Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still
Sunday night right here. What the fuck? What is tonight? Oh, yeah,
it's just Sunday anything. Night.
It's yeah. Sunday night.
It's Sunday night, not Saturday night. You done lost another day.
WBCW.
Sunday night here on WBCW, Florida's Country Radio Station, with your host, BC, me, Milford, co-host, and Tammy, and our other co-host, sitting in her lounge chair looking like she's going to go fall asleep, stretching out and
I
all
am
that.
Not. I'm not stretched out.
Yeah, you are.
I'm just...
You're stretched out. That chair's bigger than you, so it's more or less...
She's stressed out or stretched out?
Stretched.
She's both.
Yeah.
Yeah, y'all stress me out.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Never. Mercy.
Never. Not us.
Yeah.
I hope everybody had a good Sunday and Sunday afternoon. Everybody had a good day. I have kind of poured down here and around Central Florida area. If you was in Central Florida area, it got wet. But other than that, we want to say hi to everybody out there. Also with Scott Brandt, Rowdy Johnson, and all them out there. Prayers to Rowdy and his family and stuff. So just be there. Also, too, Rowdy will be coming down here in the Central Florida area doing three shows around Central Florida. You have a show at the Pops' Elks Lodge. Elks Lodge. Let me open my mouth for a minute. October.
Would you say the Elks? Would you say the
Elk Lodge?
Elk Lodge.
Yep.
Yeah. Gefilte fish.
Yeah, the gefilte fish. Now Rowdy will be here in Apopka on the 7th and the 8th. Be this October 7th. He would be at the Apopka Elks Lodge. It's a benefit for breast cancer awareness. Come out, and it's a donation event, so donations would be appreciated, and everything. So come out and see him down that night. I think the show starts at about 7 or 8 o'clock at night. All the Apopka Chamber of Commerce and everything, everybody else will be there, big wigs out of Apopka. If you cannot make that event, come out to the Bat Ranch. Rowdy's having a homecoming bash there at the Bat Ranch, so everybody in Central Florida area, all of Apopka area, Winter Garden, Sanford, wherever else where you live around the area, come out to the Bat Ranch in Apopka, Florida, off of Plymouth Rental Road. I will be there also, opening up for him, along with representing the radio station, WBCW, Florida's Country Radio Station. Gates open at 6. Just $10 at the door. Show starts at 8. It's at 7:30, 8 o'clock. So it's BYOB. Kids under 12 are free. And if you cannot make that event, come on down here in Sanford, down here on the St. John's River. I think that's where it's at. Wolfies. He'll be also playing out there. I'll be around, hanging around there that area also too. On so it'll be a fun filled packed weekend with the Rowdy Johnson band and all his fans, the friends, family members, and all that. So y'all come on out and enjoy the shows. He's starting the show off up there in Flagstaff at the Museum Club. So if you hear us out in Arizona in Flagstaff area, 23rd and 24th, Rowdy will be playing at the Flagstaff Museum Club. So he's going to have a kind of special guest with him, helping him out. So y'all come out and listen to him and follow him all the way down here to Apopka, because it's more or less going to be a Rowdy Johnson homecoming bash tour. So come on and follow him out, and let's have some fun. So if you want to take it away, Mr. BC or Tammy.
You did a good job there.
Oh, you got something to say?
Just can't wait for all that to happen. As soon as Rowdy gets into town, it should be a blast.
Yeah, it's going to be a blast.
Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Yeah, three-day weekend. And October 5th, you're going to have a Rowdy acoustic jam.
Where?
Don't know yet.
Oh.
In Apopka.
Gotcha. Is that a surprise?
I don't know where he's going to play then.
He hasn't told you.
He hadn't told me yet.
Who hasn't told you what?
Rowdy hasn't told us where he's playing on the 5th once he's in town.
Oh.
It might be right there at his house.
Yeah.
At his mama's
house or close friends.
Right.
Yeah. Family.
Right. It's probably what it is.
Yeah. So we about got the recording studio almost finished. It's getting closer every day. Since I know what I'm going to be doing tomorrow.
Exactly.
So it will be ready.
Wait, did you see the fish that Jeremy caught?
No, I ain't seen what Jeremy caught.
He went fishing
today. Oh, that sucker didn't take me.
I know. Well, it was Sunday. You know they usually go fishing.
Yeah, I know.
Him and Stephanie.
Yeah, I know.
Well, you were working.
I was mowing.
Well, I call that working.
Yep, I was mowing. Okay. Now I was playing on a zero turn, okay?
Uh-huh. And he caught a big fish. You didn't see that picture?
No, I ain't seen your picture yet.
I just wanted to see if it was a bass or what. It was huge.
About the size of you.
It looked almost as big as me. I'm going to show it to you.
Well, so it swallows you whole?
Well, I don't know about that.
I know what I need to do. Hey, BC.
What?
Why don't we go take her noodling?
What the heck is that?
There's fish out there bigger than her that swallow her whole.
Yeah. I know. Don't be doing that to me. What's wrong with you?
Hey, are you logged on to mine?
Yeah.
Turn it off and kill it, because this thing is doing the same damn thing as it was before.
No way.
I got to figure out what's going on.
All right.
I don't know. I think it must be something to do. I honestly believe somebody has plugged a... I know where it's coming from, but it's attached to the Spreaker.
Look at that big ass. What
Spreaker
is that?
Spreaker thing, I think.
That's bass.
No shit. Look
Try
at that.
Bass.
Look how big it...
That's a bass, yeah. That's a big...
Man, that's
like
a nice
mouth.
Bass.
That's about a 15-pound bass.
That could have been dinner for four of us.
No, that's his trophy.
That's his trophy?
Yeah, that's his trophy.
Man, that is nice.
I bet you he's going to take it to the taxidermy and get it stuffed.
Yeah, he won't. That's
well, my sister's a taxidermist. Does he know a taxidermist?
Yeah.
He does?
Yep.
Locally? Who?
Chris knows a taxidermist.
Chris does?
Yeah.
Taxidermist about what?
Fishing.
The fish that he caught. He thinks he's going to stuff it.
Well, why don't we just taxidermy Tammy?
You'd like that, wouldn't you? Do set me in a corner and leave me be.
Do what now?
I will come back and haunt you.
We're just going to stuff. We're going to take Tammy and get her stuffed.
That's one way of shutting me up.
Yeah. Because we sure as hell ain't going to prop her up beside the jukebox when she dies either.
Well, we just put her in the corner, handing her with a glass of wine.
Yeah, all right.
I don't like wine that much.
Or tequila.
I'll take the tequila.
Should be good and fermented by then.
Yep.
Well, thanks a lot.
You're welcome.
You brats.
Oh, mercy.
Well, I'm going to think of something good to do to you.
Yeah, you going to stuff me and put my butt in the air?
No, we're not. We're going to stuff you in 6 foot under somewhere. The barn, probably.
Yep.
Brat.
With my butt in the air.
No, your butt ain't going to be in the air.
So
we're going to roast you.
They're going to roast you. You're going to
talk about a roast. You want to do
a
roast?
We're going to have a pig roast.
We could roast you right now.
You better shut up. You do have to come home. Remember, I do have an extra room now in the barn.
Well, I got
at least it's AC.
Yeah, it's got AC. Like I said, I can go.
You got the hose for a shower.
Might as well, yeah.
I got a bathroom.
You got a bathroom.
I just need to go get some toilet paper.
Well, then you're all set up. You're ready.
Yep.
You better be nice.
I'll take my sleep. I'll take my sleep back.
Down that'll there. Be Milford's doghouse.
That's the potential doghouse.
Just be nice.
The potential doghouse, huh?
Yep.
Hmm.
It is 14 by 24.
Well.
Yeah, I guess that could be a potential doghouse. So, this thing is aggravating the piss out of me now.
Why is it doing this time? I mean,
it didn't do it.
Everything was good.
Everything was working fine.
You were even bragging about it.
Yeah, and I think for some reason, I got to figure out how to pull it out, and it's for some reason it's not letting me. I can't go and find it. It's somewhere. It's not working right. But I'll have to figure
that's
it out.
Not good.
I could do the show and everything. See, what kills me is if it's on this one and not that one. That's what I can't figure out. This one here, I already know what the problem was. That had nothing to do with the internet stuff. This one here, it's malware. I must have went to some page on like eBay or something like that and grabbed us.
That's why I do not get on eBay.
And grabbed. Well, see, I should have done it before. See, I did it before I got the firewall on there. See, now I got the firewall on there, and it's probably still on the computer. But
yeah.
Yep.
I thought you said you knew how to go in there and delete it.
I do. I just.
A
I got.
Section that you. Can
I
go
have
on.
To find it. That's the problem.
Yes.
Search me.
It's usually got a specific. Name goes with that.
Well, I already found out what the name is. It's malware. It's advertisement is what it is.
But
it's different though because I run Firefox. I'm not going through the Internet Explorer, so that's a little bit different. Oh, okay. So it's a little bit more involved.
It used to be
easier back when you frickin'. When everything was fine and dandy with computers, when I could actually tear a computer apart and put it back together.
You can't do it anymore.
No.
Well, you now, just most, throw, you throw it out and get you a new one.
That's pretty much what they want you to do.
Yeah, it is really, if you think about it.
That's how they make them. And they've got them cheap enough now that it's more expensive almost to have it fixed. Same with a dang TV.
Yep. See, I tried to log into Spreaker and it froze up on me.
Well,
I'm wondering. I don't know if it'd do any good to. Damn it. Wonder if it'd do any good to actually uninstall it. Uninstall Spreaker.
Mercy.
What?
No. Well, I shared that one. Proud to be American. If you're proud to be American, share.
Mm-hmm.
My boss, Jamie, liked it.
Does he ever like your stuff?
Yeah.
Well, what's so weird about that?
Well, he just recently started liking my stuff.
Probably because you're... advertising for him.
That's probably why he's listening.
Mr. Advertisement here.
So why are you being Mr. Advertisement?
He advertises everybody.
He even advertise you. What are you talking about?
Well,
he advertises everybody he comes
that's
across.
Because you come over here and talk on mine.
I tell him to concentrate on some of his stuff instead of putting everybody else's stuff out there. What's so funny?
Yeah, after I commented.
What did he say?
After what I said. Yeah, was it the baboon talking on the phone?
Okay.
The monkey.
Yeah, what'd he say?
He says, then I said, yep, it reminded me of someone else also. I said, lots of laugh. Then he calls Max back, by no means you're thinking of me. Who is it?
Oh, no.
He said, lots of laugh.
Don't answer.
he is a jokester. I'm going to tell you that.
Is he?
Yeah, he is a jokester.
It's funny.
Who's that?
My boss.
His boss.
Yeah. You got, they'll do anything in the world for you and stuff, as long as you're honest with them.
Well, that's right. Me, man. I'll do anything in the world for somebody as long as you're honest.
And that, and as long as you ask what that you do what they ask. I'll try to help you out, but so. Well, sorry folks, we're having technical difficulties.
Yes, we are, and one of my nightmares isn't speaking very much tonight.
I'm not having technical problems. I'm just pissed off at this computer.
Well, you can't be pissed off and get well,
still, as long as we're still broadcasting, we're fine. So I'm just listening to you guys talk while I'm trying to figure out what the hell's going on here.
Still definitely still got technical difficulties with that laptop there.
I didn't understand a word you said right there.
Yeah, his dad does that too.
Damn foreigner.
We had you winning the martyr.
I'm going to start calling you a redneck towelhead.
Hey. What do you mean, fat boy?
But, yeah, so, four swimmers in Rio today, actually this morning. One was Mike, what was his name? Lochte.
Mike Lochte.
Yeah, Lochte. He, him and three other swimmers were robbed at gunpoint this morning in Rio coming out of their hotel. And they took all their valuables and held them up at gunpoint. They were impersonating officers is what they were doing. But, you know, and it's funny because the Olympic Committee was trying to cover it up. They weren't going to even tell anybody about the thing. But then Lochte, he blew the whistle on it when they interviewed him on TV and told about it. So, yeah, they confirmed it. But, yeah, the damn Olympic Committee was going to cover it up. I don't know why, but.
Well, I'll be dang. It says Tammy Rawls is nearby.
Well, I'll be darned.
Oh, there you are. Shucks.
My other nightmare. Ah! You sound like a bird or a crow. Crazy man.
Hey.
What?
You're not saying nothing.
What?
Is that all you got to say?
Well, you said hay. Hay's for horses.
Yeah, I know that, but... hi.
Oh, my gosh. Now you sound like...
Come on, Guffy.
Yeah, that guy that turned into a girl.
What, Caitlyn Jenner?
Yeah. Little Caitlyn.
I ain't Caitlyn.
That's just
well,
me.
You just did a Caitlyn on us. Hi.
Come on, yeah.
Oh, there you are, snapping your wrist.
That scares me even.
I know. Don't be doing that. What's wrong with you?
I wasn't born right. That's what's wrong with me.
Well, you keep saying that, and I think we're definitely gathering that.
Yeah, worship. Well, I don't know.
Holy crap.
What'd you find?
Nothing. That's the problem.
That, you ain't found nothing, but it's still there.
But it's still holy crap, he says.
Holy crap.
Isn't that what Robin said to Batman?
What, holy crap?
No, it's a golly gee, Batman.
Well, it sounds similar.
That does. That's the holy... Way from holy crap to golly geez, Batman.
It was the same tone.
Don't work.
Oh my god, I gotta get these boots off.
Yeah, I can't figure out why it's doing it now because it was fine. It was fine the other day when I
uploaded it.
Yesterday you were saying it was doing good.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's a damn pain in the ass.
Well, don't worry about it right now.
It's all through the internet. Well, no, because I can't see anything. Can't even go into the chat room.
Well, that's so not good.
I mean, we can broadcast and everything, but I just can't see anybody in the chat room. I can't get on Spreaker. And that's the only time it pops up is when I pop up on Spreaker. It doesn't pop up on anything else like Facebook or really? Whatever. Yeah. Only on Spreaker.
That ain't good.
Well, that's what I'm saying. I think somebody's
hacked into your daggum thing again.
Yeah, Spreaker. Somebody hacked into somebody it. Yeah, somebody's trying to screw with me.
Yeah.
You really think that?
Oh yeah. I guarantee. Yeah, cuz there's a couple other internet stations that people were trying. Trust me, there's two stations out there that has caused problems over everybody for the last year and a half.
No kidding.
Yes.
I mean, that's pretty bad. Somebody's going to go to that length.
Oh yeah, and they do.
That's terrible.
They do.
I just can't believe people are pretty mean and hateful.
Well, here's something. Country Flow Music and Camping Festival. They're excited to have Chris Stapleton has just joined the Country Flow Music and Camping Festival.
Yeah, that's I've seen cool. that.
Really?
Yep.
I just got it.
You just got it? I've seen that like a couple of weeks ago.
That's down. He's going to be in Lake Wales. Yep.
When is it? I forget.
November 4th through the 5th.
Travis Tritt was in concert last night.
Yeah.
Well, you're going to be... No, you're going to be in October.
No, I'm leaving the 22nd.
He's in September.
You're leaving 22nd?
Of next month.
In a month.
Yeah.
I guess you let the cow out of the bag. You almost did.
Nuh-uh. I didn't. You guys are talking about...
Well, he's probably going to frickin' Gainesville.
Right.
Next month.
Yeah, so...
You ain't supposed to tell.
All right, well...
Whatever.
Supposed to go to Miami, okay?
Oh, my Lord.
Good luck down there.
Actually, Key West.
Oh, my God. Don't turn around.
I'll go to the very tip.
That's what they're banking on.
Hey.
You're too funny. You didn't even get it.
I go all the way down to the very end of Florida, the last island.
I know. That's the Keys.
The last island?
No, that's where 60 miles from Cuba.
I've never been there then.
I hope you ain't never been to Cuba.
I said... Where he's talking about that last island right before Cuba. I've been to the Keys as far as you can go on the Keys.
Oh.
But not the islands. You're talking about islands. We go snorkeling out there and stuff like that. Those islands? Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah. Way down yonder in the ocean waters.
No.
Yep. I think I may need professional help. A chef, a butler, and a maid should do it.
That's been floating around.
Yep. Scott says that. Scott Brandt, that is.
I think you need...
Speaking of professional help, if there's any doctors in the house out there listening to our radio station, we have come to the conclusion that Half Pint Tammy needs professional help. She needs professional help because she's starting to lose her mind.
No, yeah, she's
starting
crazy.
She's starting to think of things that doesn't exist.
Yeah, right. You guys are making stuff up.
We're not making stuff up. We had this talk before we even got on air.
Yeah, right? And that's because it's your assumption.
Time out, kids. Corners, please.
Your assumption.
I'm telling you.
Time out.
Okay.
Go to your rooms.
They're all a bunch of Looney Tunes.
No, you're Looney Tunes.
Go to your rooms, kids.
Go bite him. Go get him, Garfield. You going to stick your head in my boot? You better not.
Garfield, you ain't got health insurance.
Yeah, your daddy doesn't care. You can...
No, I said he ain't got health insurance. Don't do that.
He's checking him out.
There might be something in there. He's looking for rats.
Horse crap. Look, he might stick his head in there. He likes the leather. Leave him alone. Yo, meanie.
You're the old.
He's
person.
Trying to be a.
You're
cat.
The only old one here in this.
No, you're
in this
the
studio.
Old one. You ran.
You're older than I am.
No, you're old. Old.
You
thing.
Are older than I am. Thank you very much.
You better hush up. You're supposed to be being nice.
I'm.
You're not
say,
being very nice.
I haven't said anything.
Yeah, she's older than you. She's acting like she's 12 and you're only 9.
Well, yeah. There you go. See.
Yeah. Well, whatever.
Whatever.
Go to your room, kids. No TV
Come
for
on,
you tonight. Girl. No ice cream or nothing.
We already got all that out of the way.
Go to your corner.
No, you go to your corner.
I'm in
oh,
my corner.
You are in your corner.
See, you can't go. Tell me go to my corner because I'm already in my corner. And I'm being Have. I'm not arguing.
You're
bickering.
Being Have.
I'm not.
So
I'm not arguing.
Are you being Have?
Yeah, I've been having. I ain't misbehaving.
You being Have.
Whatever.
Whatever.
So, yeah, because I even took it off my cell phone to see if it was something on there, but I'll have to download it again, but I guess I'll have to screw with it later, try to figure out. Yeah, that's what happened. It's in there because now, since I got the virus protection on there, now it won't pick it up because it's already in the computer. So, I'm guessing I have to...
Yeah.
That's weird, though, that it only does it on... It only did
just
it
on a speaker.
Yeah.
Well, like you said, somebody may have put a bug on it.
Well, yeah, that's... yeah. And who else... Who would know... Who else would know... I'm sure it's got to be one of them other idiots out there. Because who else would know that we broadcast?
Yeah. So true. Yeah, so.
They're just jealous because we're better. Make them people laugh better.
No, they're a bunch of bungholes. Excuse my French. Because they are. And that's the way they've always been. They've been that way for the last year and a half. Ever since the crap hit the fan last year with all these other internet radio stations.
Yeah.
It's all right.
Yeah, I had one lady commented on my post when I was on at the other day, Friday, when I was on my 3-hour run. And then she goes,
the one that was not nice?
Yeah.
She was mean.
She being hateful.
She was very hateful.
Who's
I'm like,
this?
Where did this girl come from? She was we don't know who it was. It's just some woman just came on and said something. What'd she say?
She says, you sir are annoying. What does this have to do with anything about Milford Art? You're a asshole.
Yeah. That's exactly what she said on Facebook.
On what? On one of your posts?
Yeah, deleted it.
On my post, that when I was
live
when I,
post
on
was
my
live
on my live feed when I was on that 3-hour run, and I showed you when you seen the video of the hog, but the one I did before,
right?
That's the one she put it on.
I think that's funny.
She thought I was in Milford, Ohio, and thought my name was Milford. And what was I was using Milford, Ohio, or wherever she was from, and Kirkland, PA, put my as. And to make it my name. No, that's... Hey.
Why didn't you just put... Why didn't you just call her out on the live post and say, lady, get off your meds?
No, I won't...
Or get back on your meds.
Well, if she's... I could say her name, but I'm going to be polite about it.
He doesn't try to cause no problems like that.
But she said that you didn't know what the hell you were talking about? Is that what she said?
No, that I was annoying and all this other stuff.
Yeah, that his posts are annoying.
And they thought, and it has nothing to
you
do with...
You should ask her, well, why in the hell, lady, are you watching them all the time?
Yeah.
That's the first time we've seen her on there.
That's the first time I've seen her in a while. She used to like my post.
Oh, did she? I never even seen
her. Yeah, I've seen her a few times like my post.
I would have said that right there on the live... I said that right there on the live feed. I said, lady, then why are you watching them?
No, that was after I got off.
Yeah, it was after.
Oh, she couldn't do it while you were on the shoe check.
No.
Yeah.
Well, he can't see on his live feed anyway. He's going...
On a horse.
On a horse. He's just...
I can't see.
The sun shining.
I got to sit here and all that.
Yeah.
You got to get off to look at it. you get off to feed the live feed.
I got to pay attention and everything else because you know, telling what you can see out there.
Yeah, bear could cross.
That wild hog.
Yeah, that.
I have seen a couple panthers out there.
I'm sure the horse would know if he sees a bear or a hog or a.
No, well, yeah, they will, but you got to be ready for the whole group.
No, I can actually. They got used to the bears.
Oh, see.
And the hogs. But they'll stop at a distance, and they'll just stay and they won't stand there.
Yeah.
But when there's a panther in the area, or a bobcat, no.
There ain't too many of those out there, though, are they?
There are two confirmed panthers out there, but yet.
Yeah, but they probably travel a lot.
They probably yeah.
Well,
they're probably running around all the
time. Well, see, a male panther has 50 miles square miles. Radius
right.
For hunting. So.
Right.
Look at you. You're going to knock your cup over.
Yeah, that would have been pretty nasty.
That would have been good. Even though it's a spill cup.
Say what?
Even though it's got a spill, it's a spill cup.
Yep. It's spill proof.
Yep.
Did you see the announcement from Jeff Dane?
What about
it? Let's see if I can pull it back up. Right
well, yeah,
here.
That's the whole reason why we did the interview.
No, but he signed with Blue Moon Productions.
Never heard of him.
Yeah, Paula is associated with that.
Paula Burrell.
Paula's not Blue Moon Productions.
Okay, Blue Moon's excited to bring you country heartthrob Jeff Dane and his first video on demand streaming performance. If you love country music, you can purchase Jeff in concert. BlueMoonStage.com. Click on Purchase the Live Performances Now and navigate through to click Jeff to purchase the video. Let's see.
Well, did you get finagled out?
No.
Good for Jeff.
Yeah. Actually, there's an announcement that he made, but I can't find it right now.
No, I didn't fix it. I'm just going to stay off. I'll just have to stay off the speaker until I'm done.
My cousin just posted a picture of it. Of a poor man's grill. You know what it is? My Uncle Donnie's boy.
Let me see.
It's a hibachi.
What is it?
A hibachi.
Oh, the poor man's grill?
Yeah, it's a hibachi.
Oh, there you go.
A hibachi or hibachi?
It's a hibachi.
A hibachi.
A hibachi. Hibachi. It's kind of like you're sneezing.
No, that's when you see her walking down your road and say, ha ha, bitch!
That's not going to attract any females, that's well, for sure.
Oh, is that what you do? Ha ha, bachi.
Ha ha, bitchy.
Well, they'll just run the other way.
They just look at him running the other way. Yeah.
Oh, no, stay 5 miles of smelling man.
What'd you say?
Don't think of it. It'll come true.
I'm a Barbie girl.
Okay, so...
And Barbie's not wearing...
NBC News says all Americans will receive a microchip implant in 2017.
It won't happen.
That's what I'm saying. There's no way. I'm not taking it.
They ain't doing it to me.
All of America, it says, is
the only way that would happen is if Hillary Clinton becomes president.
If Hillary becomes president, some bad stuff's going to happen in this country.
Yeah, just like what happened in Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
And we're going to be in big trouble. Because she may be the Holy Cross, or the, what do you call it?
The Antichrist.
The Antichrist. Because everybody knows her, but she didn't see, I think Obama is, because he's the one that come out of that other country. She didn't, but she's just backing him up.
No. Obama's got people chewing his ear off, and I guarantee it's two people, Jesse Jackson and Al Sharpton, because they've been...
I totally
They've
agree.
Been part of the movement for
yep.
years.
Forever. Yeah. says they will be implanted. Those chips will be implanted to help identify individuals immediately. According to the report, the technology is used to answer one question: am I who I say I am? Some worry, however, that the RFID microchip will give the government too much power, allowing them to track every move.
That's what this whole Pokemon program was.
I believe that.
That's what the whole Pokemon, it was designed specifically for the government
to track people.
No kidding.
Yes.
So the report reveals... And
because wherever you go playing that Pokemon game, it tracks you. The GPS tracks your phone.
Well, we already have the tracking thing on our phones.
Right. But right now, the government has to have permission to track you.
Well, see, here's the biggest thing.
If you're playing a game, Pokemon, it's automatically out there in the open. So they can see where you're going and what you're doing.
This is what I have read, like, a couple years back when they were talking about this chip. Well, here's the biggest thing they're going to implicate into it. Is it was reported that the use of the microchips in Bill H.R. 4872 was located... under the National Medical Device Registry. What they're going to be trying to do is all your medical records are going to be downloaded onto your chip so that you don't even have to go to a doctor. And if there's anything wrong with you, it's going to automatically go to your doctor, your primary doctor.
Yeah, but there's no sense in having that now because if Trump gets in there, he's going to abolish Obamacare.
Well, that's if Trump gets in.
That's the whole... Well,
they say if Trump gets in, they're going to have him assassinated.
You mean like they did Kennedy?
Obama and them, yeah.
Well, if they do, then so be it. I mean,
but anyway,
tells you right there where our government's heading to.
Yeah, that's right. And I think if Hillary gets in, that's when all
people,
this is
people,
fall apart.
People of the United States just needs to understand that. It's true, like that video. If you've ever seen that video that I've posted before on Facebook, the United States is not the greatest country to live in anymore.
I know. I found that out through some.
Let me tell you what Florida just passed too. There's a bill in the House and Senate that both passed through them. Now it's got to go through the governor. There's going to be a law now into effect that divorce cases in the state of Florida. It's no longer going to be divided. It's no longer going to go for the man or the woman. It's going to be split 50-50 for custody of the children. You will have to literally prove that the other one is either crazy, nuts, doesn't have a job, doesn't have a house or nothing to prove that you have to have full custody.
Well, there you go. Monica doesn't have a house, nor does she have a job, nor will she get a job. And she's crazy. And
that's the only way that she'll get full custody. But as of when this bill passed, coming October, mm-hmm. You go for a file for a divorce, and there's children involved. They will bring the children up to testify against the parents, and the responsibilities will be split 50-50 right off the bat.
Wow!
No more of this 2 weeks during the summertime and every other weekend and stuff like that.
That will work out good for.
Well, some doctors...
My son.
Some doctors and psychologists said it'll be detrimental to the kids. Because the kids, if you drag the kids in the...
court, then they got to hear everything.
Right. I understand the split to 50-50 with the parents, but why drag the kids involved?
Yeah.
Well, kids are
it's not their fault.
Yeah, because they'll be drugged.
It's not their fault. They're not going to pick and choose whether to tell on their mom or dad. They're not going to do it.
Yeah, I know. And, of course, going to make them be drugged.
Make them be what?
Drugged.
Drugged?
Nah, yeah. Courts won't do that.
Yeah, they will.
What do you mean?
They'll drug them. Because it'll be taking them. The mom will be drugging from one house and drugged to the other house.
Jeez.
And back and forth to the other house.
You know, if you hadn't said here, that drug part, there. We would have never
realized.
You've
been hanging outside too much. 9:32 Sunday, right here at WBCW.
You forgot to mention you had a girlfriend for 5 whole years. I was sitting at home, watching my phone, waiting to hear from you, but you never called. You were living a double life while I was on the other side, hidden from the truth. I always wondered if I'd ever be good enough for you. I bet you. your clothes. Sold your guitar for $20 to a guy on the side of the road. For 5 whole years.
Sunday night right here at WBD.
Tonight.
WBCW radio.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I done got it. He done hanging around me too much, so he goes too fast. It's WBCW.
It's pretty easy
I'm
to do if you're
into
not.
Milford.
You'll never turn into me because there's only one of me.
Wishful thinking on your part, huh?
God help me if
this comes natural.
Yeah, his craziness comes natural.
Oh, yeah, I know that.
Yeah, I meet the rest of my family.
No, I think
Francis ain't as nutty as you are.
I think you're the craziest.
Yeah.
Meet my grand uncle Roy.
Oh, really?
Oh, gosh. 82 years. He's 81.
Oh.
And he is crazy. He's nuttier.
Where does he live?
Georgia.
Oh, I want to meet him one day.
Like I said, I got family in Georgia everywhere. My dad said I ain't got family in Las Vegas.
You do?
Yep.
Settled down or just working?
Settled down. I got family in Germany.
Okay, cousin of cousin of cousin.
My son and my daughter-in-law is in Germany. That's family.
Ha ha. That's right. I know this.
Okay, then. I got family in Germany.
Shut up. What are you trying to brag? You got family everywhere?
I got family everywhere, ma'am. I got family everywhere.
Crazy. All right. I'm not going to brag about that.
We got 14 listeners.
Really? Yay! Hello, everybody.
But how did you see that other person in there? Because there's nobody
in there. She's on the top.
It's the top where she liked the
button. You
know
where?
Hi, Miss Ann.
Oh, she liked it. Oh.
Yeah,
she liked
so it. She's got her icon up there.
It's flowers, magnolias.
Yeah. Huh?
It's magnolia flowers.
I don't see that.
You don't see it? It's between me and Milford.
Not anymore.
Yeah, it is. I see it right there.
She's not on the main page.
Is she on the main page?
Here she is, right there.
No, I don't see that.
Huh.
Yeah, I know you don't see that.
Yeah, no, I don't see that.
Oh, well, we get to see that, and you don't. Is that how
see,
it
we're privileged.
Yeah, we're privileged.
No, it's because you're on the phone app. You're not on the computer app. The computer apps are the whole difference.
Yeah, I know.
So, the Top 20 Countdown ends this coming Saturday at 11 p.m. Eastern, and then we'll air the show Sunday at 8 p.m.
Yeah, get out there and vote 10 times a day.
Yeah.
Make sure you go to vote, WBCWradio.com, and go to the Top 20 Countdown page and make sure you vote.
Vote for your favorite artist.
Who's your favorite artist? You.
Rowdy Johnson.
I know that. Well, listen to you. That's your favorite artist.
Yeah.
Okay.
But the question is, who's everybody's who's favorite artist?
Okay, so for you, it would be your song, Broken Cowboy.
Yeah.
It's already at number 3.
You ain't supposed to say anything.
No, it's at number 3. It's been at number 3.
Yeah, it's been at number 3 since last week. Last countdown, people.
Yeah, the last countdown.
Yeah, the last countdown, yeah.
You got to say it specifically.
Are Are you having a hard time?
What the hell's wrong with everybody tonight? You guys can't talk.
You can't talk either, so.
We're all just not being able to talk tonight.
That's because,
that Cracker Barrel.
There's an old saying. It says to make a mistake is only human to really
flub up.
Foobar things up, takes a computer.
When it's done, if it's the old-fashioned way, it never gets flubbed up. When new stuff comes in, it gets flubbed up.
Yeah. So anyways, let's talk real quick about this situation in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. They practically burnt down Milwaukee last night.
Did they?
Yes, they did.
So what do you mean?
The situation happened. A black officer was running down a suspect who was a black male and had a gun on him. Well, he pulled the gun out and it looked like he was turning towards the cop to shoot at him, and the cop shot him dead.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. So
he had a gun, right?
They burned down the AutoZone. They burned down 7 cruisers up there.
That's crazy.
They burned down a beauty supply store. They implemented martial law last night, brought out the...
Wow, that's pretty serious.
Brought out the National Guard and everything.
Well, he had a gun.
Right.
And he was running from him. So if you have a gun and you're running from the law.
So this tells me right here that this one here wasn't racial motivated. Couldn't have been. Because it was a black cop shooting a black kid.
Exactly.
There wasn't no white cop shooting a black kid.
Exactly. Or vice versa. Yeah.
Now it's just about the cops. It's about the cops now.
But a cop is typically, that's his job. If you got a gun and you're running and you did a crime, they can shoot you because that guy turned around to shoot the cop.
People need to understand. I don't care, people, if you're Republican, Democrat, liberal, you got your panties all up in a wad. If a cop tells you to stop, you better stop.
That's right. It's the law. It's a law telling you.
Yeah.
Imagine if
you don't stop and the cop feels threatened, you're going to get shot, period.
That's right. Everybody knows that. It's only common sense.
Yep.
Well, nowadays, people ain't got common sense anymore.
Well, evidently not. So.
No, it's kind of like the post that I posted here today. Let me see.
Yeah, I read a little bit of it.
Doing the wrong thing, you know what the law is.
The post I put up. The post I put up earlier today was, I grew up in a time where children gave respect to get respect. Now, they expect respect in order to give respect.
Yeah, that's wrong.
And that's where our problem with today's society is, with the kids.
Well, that's backwards.
They need to bring back paddling in schools.
Yep.
Corporal punishment.
Yep.
Definitely.
Parents, raise your kids the right way, damn it. Because if you don't, our world's going to come to a point.
Well, that's the problem. They're not raising their kids. They're having them, but they ain't raising them.
Our world's going to come to a point where it's going to be overrun by idiots that don't know their butt from the hole in the ground. And then we're going to be in a world of hurt. And then it's going to be mass hysteria everywhere.
Yep.
And the Bible says that God ain't going to destroy us. We're going to destroy ourselves before he even comes back.
Yeah. We're doing it.
Yep. Now,
man is corrupting and ruining the world.
Yep.
All by ourselves.
Yep. Maybe what they ought to do is go ahead and put Bibles back in school and teach about it.
Well, they took all that
away. They want to put the Quran in school. People are hollering and pitching a fit because they want the Quran in school, but they won't let the Bible in school.
Yeah, that's...
They took out prayers. They took out Pledge of Allegiance.
Yeah. You can't even say anything relating to either one of those.
But you can say anything about Allah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But if you say anything about somebody black or somebody white or somebody...
You say one wrong thing about somebody else...
Authentic.
Yep. All hell breaks loose.
Then forget it.
But I realize, too, it all depends on what age group you're in, what generation.
That's true.
Because your older generation have respect for one another and help...
They were raised that way.
If you did one wrong thing... you better run to your room
and lock
the door.
Well, no, because your mom and dad would be right behind you to beat the door down and
that's
your butt.
Yep.
So you best say, yes, ma'am, no, sir, no, ma'am, yes, sir.
I mean, they'd say, what'd you hit? You could say, what'd you hit me for, Ma? For general purpose or just in case you needed it. or something.
And even in school. If you got your butt beat in school, you definitely know you were going to get it from home when you got home from your parents.
And even when I was going to school, no matter whatever you did, if I didn't do anything or not, which most of the time I did, I always got in trouble. I remember in junior high, Mr. Bowling, Tommy Bowling. Bowling. He was a vice principal. He used to come in, and I used to go on there. I'd do something, done something in class, and they kept on telling me, and I got detention, and then the detention sent me to vice president.
Had vice Mr. Bowling, principal?
Vice principal.
Vice principal.
And then Mr. Bowling would say, all right, bend over. He had a daggum paddle this long.
That's right.
About 3 feet, about 2.5 foot long.
And they drilled holes in
it.
And it had holes in it.
I know. That hurt harder.
About 3 licks.
That was all it took.
That's all it took. But I didn't have, no, me.
But they didn't call your parents. They
You said yes, sir, no, sir. And it's like, you took your licks.
And then you went on back to class.
Yep. My mom got to the point where she got tired of them calling her. And she said, you take care of it. I ain't coming up there to get them.
Yeah, and that's the thing. It's like, I got my licks. And after I got my licks, I ain't got no butt anyways. I didn't have no butt back in school. So my butt was so darn hard. And I got a hard butt anyways.
You mean a hard head?
That too.
Okay.
Both.
Mm-hmm.
Hard head or hard butt.
Okay. You said you just don't have a butt.
Yeah, I don't got no butt at all.
Okay.
You got the no ass at all.
Okay, keep going on.
But anyways, after all that said and done, he come up to me and said, hey, you got some stuff on you? I said, yep. He take me, Levi Garrett. So you got any chewing back on? I said, yep. So he said, let me see it. Take it back, and then I'll take a chew of my chew in the back and hand it right back to me. We both sit there and talk.
That's how the principals go. That's how most principals kept in cigarettes.
So you got a whooping.
They took the kids. They took the kids.
No,
cigarettes
he just said he handed it back to him though.
Yeah, handed it back to me and wanted to use my pocket knife and all that.
No kidding.
He was a good old country boy, but he made his point.
Mm-hmm. What was his point?
Don't do it again. Whatever you did.
Okay.
I'll tell you a story. I got in trouble in first grade. I was 6 years old. They called my parents and said, now this was at a Christian school. They called my parents and said that I was looking at dirty magazines.
Uh-oh. Well, that ain't changed. You didn't learn nothing.
They come up to the school and wanted to know what was going on, so he showed them the magazines, and I remember looking at them. It was the National Geographic magazines that my parents donated to the school.
No way.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
And they called them dirty magazines.
They did?
Mm-hmm.
Probably because they had them with the...
Well, they had them on the bookshelves and everything, and that's... You know, they...
Well, back
my
then...
dad said, what... My dad basically, my dad told the principal, he said, what the hell are you calling me for this for? We donated these magazines to you because you guys wanted them.
And now
you're complaining that he's looking at dirty magazines.
Oh, gosh. That's too funny. Yeah. Well, people weren't used to seeing stuff like that.
Well, and in a Christian school.
Especially Christian school.
They should have realized it before they accepted them.
Isn't that ridiculous? I can't believe that.
I'm thinking, you got to be kidding me. So, who knows? 9:49, right here, WBCW.
Been treading in water so deep. Never stopping. Forgot how to sleep. What's been forbidden?
we're caught up in again. Rebels on the run, we're highway women, gypsies on the on the road, an outlaw on the go, maybe wanted everywhere, lock us up, we don't care, strong at heart even though we may be sinning, strong at heart even though we may be sinning.
WBCW Sunday night. Tammy's nightmare.
Yeah, that's these two right here. That's my nightmares.
Whatever.
That's right. Milford and BC. My two nightmares. So it says, Greta Van Susteren says, should Americans pay for Obama's 18% pay increase he's giving himself?
Hell no.
Hell no. The vets need money more than Obama.
He'll give him his, he'll get it, he'll get it, he'll get his increase and all
I
that.
I can't believe he put in for an increase.
Why not? He's leaving because once he leaves, whatever he was making, that's what he gets for the rest of his life.
That's crazy.
Once they leave, I think they should not get it.
Yeah, once they leave office, I think they shouldn't have it. Why should he have it?
That's with all politicians.
Well, no, well, it shouldn't be as high. They get something like $500,000 a year, no matter what.
Well, they need to knock it
for
down.
For life.
That's more than we make in 6 years.
Shoot, that's more I'm making
a
lifetime.
More than a lot of people make in a lifetime.
In a lifetime, right. I think
that's in two lifetimes for me.
And then you'll have people, but then you'll have people, but then you'll have people, then you'll have people saying, well,
my lifetime and my horse's lifetime.
You'll have people say, well, the reason they get paid that is because of everything that they know. See, every president that comes through knows a lot. If they ever got kidnapped or hoonswaddled or whatever, there's a lot of information that they know.
Well, he's not the only one.
That's why they got Secret Service protection all the time for the rest of their life and everything.
Yeah. Well, remember what we talked about? The secret.
Oh, the secret society?
The secret society, the Illuminati. They're all part of that. They're all intertwined. There's FBI, retired FBI official that went public.
There's a group that's been out there that's got a building in Washington that's twice the size of the Lincoln Memorial.
Yep.
And they're called the Masons, and they're the most powerful
group. They're the Illuminati, part of the Illuminati.
In the world. They could actually change the world if they wanted to, but
well,
they choose not to.
Do you know where it started is the New World Order. That's what they're trying to implicate from 18-something. They started
1862.
This. 1862, they started this, and the Masons are now a major player in that.
Thomas Jefferson, one of the original signatures of the Constitution, was
a Mason. He was a Freemason.
He was a third-degree Mason.
Yep. That's what I'm saying. And anyway, there's a lot of that that's just not just been revealed, but a lot of people know about it. There's
Ben
so
Franklin
many that
was
don't.
Too.
But it's coming out now because of these elections.
Oh, yeah.
There's a lot of things coming out.
Well, a lot of stuff's going on, too, right now, because that way what they do is they try to keep people's minds off of what's going on in electrics and elections. And what's going on at the White House, because Obama's doing everything he can to do what he says he's going to do until he's out of office in October. Or, excuse me, January.
He needs to be out now.
Well,
he should have been out 4 years ago.
He should have been out 8 years ago.
That's right. I totally agree.
Yeah, because nobody, I mean, I didn't even know who he was 8 years ago when he got, you know, the president. I said, who's this guy?
Yeah, he was groomed to be right where he's at.
He was. He was only in.
He was born and raised and groomed to be.
Yep. He was only popular up till like the first couple months before they did the elections, because I didn't know who he was.
Nobody did.
He was the gopher in Congress.
Well, yeah.
He was low profile, just how they wanted him. And then all of a sudden he hit the scene fully loaded with money, with power, with all the backings of the Arab Arabs and the what are them people called that he's from.
I'm wearing my Speedo, Scott.
Oh my gosh. No, he isn't, because if he was, I would not be in this room.
Yeah,
anybody? Scott says Tammy's nightmare. BC, did you just get naked?
I would be gone, Scott.
No, she wouldn't, Scott. She'd be
sitting right
there.
I would be gone, and Milford could stay, but I would be gone.
They could
be getting in there. Don't do it. Stop it. Keep your dang clothes on, dude.
Go get your bra on.
He keeps threatening Scott.
Free Willy. That was a movie.
Jeez Louise.
You ain't never seen that movie?
Of course.
No, you haven't.
Yes, I have.
You haven't even seen Short Circuit.
I would never see that, but everybody's seen Free Willy.
Scott, she has never seen the movie Short Circuit.
I'm not like you guys. You guys are weird.
Short Circuit was not a weird movie.
Hey, look, you asked three girls, three pretty girls. Did we ever see it? No. None of us seen it.
Okay. I can understand the other two because they were 25 and 18.
19.
You, on the other hand, are older than both of us.
Well, I don't watch them kind of movies. Only guys that think stuff like that's funny watch it.
Whatever.
I thought you liked comedy.
I do, but not that kind of comedy.
What kind of comedy is it?
Well, I don't know.
Well, then how can you judge and say you don't like the movie if you ain't seen it?
Because I haven't seen it.
You're digging yourself farther in this hole here.
Plenty of people haven't seen it.
Yeah, it's gone to 8 feet hole, or 8 feet deep now.
It ain't no more 15-second delay anymore. It's a 10-foot hole.
They made me turn my delay
Whatever.
Off.
It's a 10-foot hole.
They literally
and it's getting deeper.
Made me turn my delay off. My settings
new nickname for Tammy. It's not Hive Pint anymore. It's Quicksand Tammy.
Oh, stop. No, it is not.
Because every time you say something, you just keep going deeper and deeper.
Okay.
Deeper. 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 Yeah, anyways, on another note, I just get tired of people wanting the stuff and say they're handicapped when they're actually not, and they just got other problems that don't really have problems and get from the government and all that.
Oh,
they get
yeah.
all these free handouts and they are able to work.
Yeah.
But yet, the video I showed, and we looked at earlier about this one guy has been playing guitar with no arms, no hands, just playing with his feet. He's been playing since he was 12 years old.
And he does pretty good.
And he sings daggum good, too.
Mm-hmm.
And if no matter what kind of impairment, the people that are truly handicapped are showing you that if you put your mind to it and get out and do stuff and quit being sulking in your own sorrows and wallows and all that, you'll be a lot happier in life and quit looking what you have not and start looking what you have.
That's right.
You know, and that there's a lot. I get really mad about a lot of that stuff, and I just kind of, you know, when I see our soldiers come over with limbs cut off, you know, blown off and stuff like that, you know, I kind of worry about it with my son Stevie over there. Even though he cooks, he's still in danger. You know, he cooks for the whole regiment that he's in that's over there, and he comes, you know, even though if you have arm or limb or stuff like that that's coming home, they're knowing they're handicapped, but they get over that mindset and get it up and get in gear that are able to, even as ones that have brain damage and stuff like that coming out, and they're actually doing stuff.
And they got to come home and get a job. And
they're getting a job.
Support their family still.
Yep, they're getting it and they're doing a job. Yeah. Their family's helping them out, but yet they want to be their own, back to what it used to be.
That's right.
And full force and a whole nine yards. And nowadays we have,
and they don't get near what the people that get free stuff get.
No, and you know, yeah, I know. You get the people that's on these government programs get a lot more what our servicemen and women get.
Yeah, people that fought to die for our country.
Yeah, and I know. It gets me mad about all that. You know, and I see a lot of these even young kids and stuff. It's got cancer and. I got to see some of these commercials and stuff. And these young kids, anywhere from 4 to 12 to 13 years old and on up, you know, they're fighting for their life, but yet they have a good outlook on life. And that's a shame that we have grown men and women that want to sit around
and cry
about their problems.
See what they can get free off of other people or the government or whatever.
Yeah, and collect food stamps.
And there's a lot of people that do that too.
Yeah, yeah. No,
and they don't think twice about it.
You know, if they grew up like I did, like my mom and my dad, and actually my granddaddy brought me up, my dad's dad, I was out working at age 5.
Not officially, but you were doing things like around the house or
No, I was not. I was working the greenhouse and stuff like that.
Well, that's because you were in that family that worked greenhouses.
Yeah, greenhouse and I was working. At the time, I was about 6 and a half, 7 years old.
I was too. My parents were in a janitorial service, so 6 days a week all of my life.
Yeah.
From the time I can remember, we had to go.
No wonder you squeaky clean.
And there was 5 of us girls, mind you. It was called Family Affair Janitorial. We had to go 6 days a week to clean offices.
Yeah, well, I used to go out and cut 10 acres when I was 7 years old.
Yeah, they worked. Were a kid, you got worked.
Yeah, you earned your daggum keep back
then.
Nowadays, everybody's on.
And on Saturday and Sunday, we'd have to shine windows with vinegar and paper in newspaper, or we'd have to pick weeds, or we'd have to do something. We couldn't just go play.
And you know, I had to get up. I had my calves, I had my chickens, my hogs, my dogs go out and water.
I wish I grew up like that.
And I had that.
He's trying to get that.
I know, but what I'm saying is
animal instinct going.
And I had to go water to a 150 foot greenhouse along with a 300 foot greenhouse. Go out there and check
We got some chickens in the house.
Big chicken over here. But, anyhow.
Oh, we got a rooster.
That's a dead rooster.
He sounded pretty loud to me. Oh, there's a rooster.
That sounds like you were choking your chicken.
There's a, there's a rooster show off here.
But yeah, anyways, you got grown men and women playing video games, playing Pokemon, doing
walking
this,
around, yeah, walking like around. They ain't got nothing to do.
And then you got, and then the kids are following suit, and you sitting here not paying attention to what you're doing. You know, it kind of irritates me.
Hey, all right, Piggy. There's a piggy in the house.
I see Mr. Oinker across the table.
Mr.
Here.
Oinker. Well, that's a good pig. Well, he had your rooster beat though. Don't choke on.
He's choking on his chicken over there.
Yep.
Yeah,
I understand what you're saying.
So.
So
if y'all,
that was a good rant.
Yeah, I can get along. And once I get going on subjects and stuff, I pretend not to do it because I'll get mad.
Of course it's controversial.
It's controversial.
It's your opinion. It's the way we were raised. But that is what worked for a long time. And now you see what's not working out there. And in society.
It's because Americans have gotten too damn lazy that they want to put all the work on everybody else.
That's right.
Yep.
And they don't want to do the work. So that's why
there's a reason why they can't do it.
That's why there's cheap labor. That's why a lot of the government people are pitching a fit because they want to close the borders. Because if that happens, we're going to lose all of our production on most of our crops, our vegetable pickers, our fruit pickers, because that's what most of them people come over to do.
Yep. And we got too fat of a lazy.
Americans have gotten too damn lazy to do any work themselves.
Yeah, fat and lazy to do anything by themselves.
Well, the government gives away everything for free.
Yep.
Well, while I look at the government programs, they need to go in and actually check the family.
Well, if you think about it,
the family, they need to monitor the family.
But if you think about it, though, if you think about it with our government, us as society has actually put the government in that predicament because they figure it'd be cheaper to control us and take so much money like they've done over in Germany and Russia and all them for you. They take like something like 95% of their paycheck every week. The government does. They give them a few hundred bucks to live on each week to do whatever. But yet their insurance and health care and everything else is taken over. That may be fine and dandy, but that's been implemented over there for hundreds and hundreds of years. They're trying to take 350 million plus people in the United States and do that overnight. And it's not going to work.
Well, if they don't watch it, people don't watch it, what's going on out there, and open their eyeballs and stuff and look and watch what their surroundings are closely, socialism and communism are pretty much close to the same.
Yeah.
And it's going to wind up. It's going to be like another Cuba, like what was back down in Cuba until they open, change things the way they're thinking.
Socialism is what they're gearing towards.
Yeah, I know. But we're supposed to be an independent nation of helping.
Supposed to be.
And a capitalist, mm-hmm. a capitalism nation. But yet, people are giving their rights away. They're doing this, that, and the other. And they're dumbfounding. They're dumbing themselves down.
Yeah.
They're not thinking for themselves and say, well, okay, what do you want me to do?
I've talked to people here in the States that's from Cuba or from another country, and they're saying, man, I feel sorry for you guys because you're ending up just like the
Cuba.
Way our just like our countries are.
Yeah.
We're heading towards that way.
So Scott said he was picking beans in Florida at age 12. Then he said he always paid for his own guitars and stuff.
He was chasing them beans at 12. What are you talking about?
And, what do you say here? He says he's always paid for his own guitars and stuff and his own school clothes, too.
Yeah, I do, too. whenever I had money and stuff. I at age 15, Scott, I was in Georgia, up there in Valdosta and equipment up around Thomasville, either baling hay or cutting hay, and then going out in the watermelon fields and stuff and picking up about 60 pound Georgia Jubilees and tossing them up and loading trucks and all that off the ground, you know.
Nowadays, our kids don't do anything but go to school, come home, and get on the computer or on their phone now.
Yeah.
Look at Blaine. He was over.
Yeah, no.
This weekend, and he stayed in the room whole time on his phone. Playing video games.
I raised holy hell when my ex-wife gave my daughter a phone at the age of 8 years old.
Well, he's 13. He just turned 13.
She said, well, they were walking to school at the time. I can understand that point. But the fact is, I made a point. I says, why in the hell does these kids need all this shit when they're going to be in school during the day anyways?
Yeah.
They don't need it. And if you're in school, you know where your kids are. You should know where your kids are at.
Yep.
Well, so many don't. That is.
And now they come up with an excuse, well, the kids need this stuff in school, the laptops and iPads and stuff like that. To do their schoolwork and stuff. What the hell happened to doing research and books and going to the library?
And thinking for themselves.
Well, see, it's technology, though.
So, I've always said it. Technology is going to be the death of the world, and it's heading that way.
Mm-hmm. That's true, because now they don't have to do anything. It's just so easy.
People might as well stop talking about McDonald's, because McDonald's ain't making people fat anymore. People's making people fat.
That's right. And Scott says he was cutting lawns in Deltona, 15 accounts, $5 to $7 each. And that's another thing.
He was clearing out them trees over there for the city of Deltona. Because when he lived over there, there wasn't much over there.
Well, you know, nowadays you tell the kids to go get a job. And if it's only $5 or cut a lawn for $15, that's not enough money for them. So they're not motivated. You know, to me... You know, you saved
back then. $15 a yard was a lot of damn money for a kid.
Well, I'm talking now.
Yeah, even $5 was a lot for me.
Well, like now, I tell him go mow a lawn. I would match my son's whatever he made for summer. I would match him, and that's what he'd get for school clothes.
I got $1 a week, and that was to go buy a Hot Wheels car.
Well, that's pretty sad.
I should have kept them.
If I'd
have kept them all, they'd be worth a lot of damn money right now.
Yeah,
that's true.
And Tonka toys.
I got to go play.
That's us. If we did our chores and we did them right, we got to go play.
Well, we had to learn. Me and my sister Angie had to go learn. Pretty much raise our own selves. We took care of each other, and we learned how to take. My mom showed us how to wash clothes.
Yeah.
And cook something for our own selves, the whole nine yards. And while they was at work, we was come in for school. When we lived out in Lake Norris and stuff off of Ebersol, back in that one more way and stuff back there, and the bus stop was like 3 miles from the house. We walk, get off the bus stop at the lake, and walk all the way in the back, get up in the morning, do the same thing over again. But every time in the morning, I'd had to get up, feed all the animals and stuff like that,
and then go to school,
then walk to the bus stop, then come back in.
And do it all over again.
And go back all over again. If I got done before dark time, I got to go ride my horse.
See?
I just figured out.
But that made you appreciate stuff.
Yeah.
I just figured out something. Scott ain't American. He's Mexican. Because he says for $2, he'd go get a beef and bean burrito and a big gulp down at the 7-Eleven.
Oh, shoot.
Yeah.
I used to get Copenhagen for 35 cents.
You've been chewing tobacco that long?
Yep. Oh, yeah. Back in college, I used to get a pouch of Beech Nut for like $2 or $3. It was either Beech Nut or Red Man.
Me, it was Levi Garrett.
When I smoked for 15 years. When it got to the point when cigarettes were $7 a pack, I said, the hell with
$7?
That. $7? They still are. That's about how much
I stopped when it was like before $4. It was like $3-something. When it was $3-something, I said,
it's been 7 years now since I've picked up a cigarette.
$7? For a pack of cigarettes?
That was Marlboros. I smoked the Marlboro Reds.
Whoa.
That's all I smoked.
That's crazy. Yeah. I would not pay that kind of money for.
Well, my granddaddy started me on when I was about 6 on that old Bloodhound or Applejack chewing tobacco. That's that hard block chewing tobacco, square block like this.
Oh, yeah.
I remember the blocks.
Yeah.
Yep. No kidding.
Yep.
That's gross.
I was my granddaddy's boy.
And the pouches have been around for years because I even tried the pouches when I was in high school.
Then my mom, old Glover, my dad's mom, got me started on that peach snuff in the can.
How was that?
It's powdered.
Ew.
Yeah, powdered peach snuff.
That had to have been nasty.
You had to take.
Did you like it?
A can. It was like this, this tall, this big around. What you would do, I would do, I come in there and put in the lid of the can, some of the powdered snuff, stick it in my lip, pour it in my lip, and then close the can up.
And how long would it stay being as powder? Wouldn't it disintegrate?
No, it packs in.
No way.
Yep.
That sounds nasty.
That's the first time I heard about the powder.
About the powder. The powder sounds nasty.
You want something?
That's not powder.
No, but it's long cut.
All I got to do is kiss you to get that.
It's wintergreen.
I like the wintergreen, actually. Yeah, the powder sounds nasty, though. It sounds like it would, like, get all over.
Oh, she was
in your mouth and all.
When I was junior high, I used to do the either Levi Garrett or just Copenhagen. Only had one type of Copenhagen, the original. We used to take a Jim Beam or something like that, or Jack Daniel's.
I like Jim Beam.
And pour it and just put a tad in there in our cans. And when we got on, when I was in FFA, we used to do that. And we'd go to events and all that. Pour in there. We'd have drinking alcohol.
Hold on before you say anything. Tammy, tell me what FFA stands for.
I don't know what FFA stands for.
You know what 4-H is, right?
Yeah.
What does that stand for?
Not the kind that you deal with your kids or you put them in school. This is something different.
Oh, well, no, I'm talking about with 4-H. The only thing I know 4-H.
That's for kids. That's for daycare.
Kids in school.
Yeah. FFA, Future Farmers of America.
Okay.
That was a club that they had back in high school.
Oh, gotcha.
They still do.
Yeah. Some schools.
Some schools still have FFA.
I wished I had that.
I was in FFA for 6 years.
Yeah, that. Yeah, Scott had shop class.
Go ahead.
Yeah, I see what Scott says.
Scott said he's Crow Indian, not Mexican.
Yeah, I know he's Crow.
He's calling him Mexican. Well,
no. So he was eating Crow tacos. Crow burritos.
He says, Milford, you've been chewing since age 5.
Yep.
It's amazing your teeth are not rotted out.
On and off all this time.
That's why he lost his front tooth.
Or totally brown. Totally brown teeth.
No, I've always had good teeth. Until a time of gear hit me in the mouth.
Good thing, huh? Because you know what they say about horses, got to have good teeth and good hoofs.
You know, Medicaid will pull your teeth out for you for one time and give you a free set of dentures.
Oh, yeah.
I don't need them all my teeth. I just pulled out. I just need one flipper.
He needs one put back in.
I need one put back in. That's all I need.
They ain't got a drill bit big enough for that.
My dentist was begging him a dog.
If your dentist knew you were calling her a dog, she'd be mad at you.
I didn't call her a dog. I said my dentist, and he came in with a dog.
Oh, there we go.
You mutt.
Come on, let's hear a dog fight. He sounds mean. He's gonna let you get your rant out. Oh, you sound like a frickin' Dobie or something. Now let's hear what you got. Oh, the pussycat's coming out.
You wanna hear what I got? Get off my front porch! Ten 19 p.m. right here, Sunday. Tammy's nightmares. Hold on while I go put the dog
That's
on
what
the
I'm
chain.
Saying.
We'll be right back.
Let me get this dog.
Dixie sunshine, northern rain. That Yankee winter's come to haunt me again. Cold as a love gone bad, cuts to your soul. Leaves you face to face with all that you can't control. Sulfur sunsets, skyline blues. Being lost was easier than learning to lose. So Dixie sunshine, come again. I got some memories, but I ain't got no friends.
Concrete canyons, glass mountains to the sky.
How long to see the day we can say goodbye?
I'm dreaming of a country with a fever in my brain and coming down with heartache in a New York City rain. So Dixie sunshine, where do you shine? Like I remember from that childhood of mine. I got a notion that I'll come around, and the gentle hills of Dixieland is where I lay me down. Concrete canyons, glass mountains to the sky.
New York City, there you are. Where the hell am I?
I'm dreaming of the country with a fever in my brain and coming down with heartache
in the New York City rain.
Concrete canyons, glass mountains to the sky.
New York City, there you are. Where the hell am I?
I'm dreaming of the country with a fever in my brain and coming down with heartache in the New York City rain. Yeah, that rain, New York City rain.
Got friends with Douglas after
WBCW Sunday night, Tammy's nightmare. So we're talking about Facebook here and how
everybody knows everybody. Like, you could have a friend that knows everybody in your friends list, but you won't know their picture. You don't even know who they are.
Right.
But yet they know everybody in your whole friend circle. It's kind of weird. And then they keep expanding. When you get new people, they expand onto your new people. And they get into those connections. So it makes you wonder, who is it?
Yeah, because you never really know.
Yeah. What are you laughing at?
Michelle's giving me crap because I posted on Facebook earlier that it says here, you know it must have been a good night last night when you wake up in the morning and you go rub your eyes and you still got hot sauce underneath your fingernails. Because I had chicken wings last night.
Oh, no.
And Michelle says, then why did you still have hot sauce under your nails, huh?
Because you didn't wash them.
Well, and she says, and that tells me that you don't take a bath or a shower before you go to bed. I take a showers in the morning, too. I was so tired, I just ate my chicken wings and went to bed.
He goes...
No, it didn't sound like that, because this morning when I got up, it sounded like, under there, woo! It was running out, baby.
Oh, that was a good one. That's a good rooster. You just beat BC on a rooster.
Yeah, my cock was bigger than his.
That's what they all say. Us girls, we don't. That's not what we always hear.
Rooster wise, okay?
Okay. I know you had a little bit of...
No.
Whatever.
We was talking chickens and roosters.
We were talking roosters, no chickens.
Hey, I've always said Tammy's got the dirtiest mind in this bunch.
We were only talking...
Whatever. I've roosters. Always said that you got the dirtiest mind in this
He
bunch.
Said it, not me.
That's what a rooster is. It's a cock.
Yeah, but you were thinking about it.
Oh, well, no kidding.
Yeah.
So you had to say you had the bigger cock than the other guy, right?
Yeah, my cock.
They all say that.
Yeah, my cock was bigger than his because he crowed bigger.
Okay. Okay. You should have never said that, huh?
Yeah, my cock was crowing.
Okay, let me see that cock crowing. And you call that bigger than his?
Yep.
Okay. Like I said, they all say that.
Or I could go,
oh, well, now you don't sound bigger than him. Well, now you're just an inch.
There's a centimeter, Peter.
Ah, who's got the dirty mind floating now?
You had that.
No, I didn't.
You were thinking about
it. You said it.
You were thinking about it.
Well, you said it.
I seen your eyeballs.
No, that's right. And so did everybody else on the other end.
Y'all ain't right, man. I'm telling you.
You know what? You said it on purpose. You are bad tonight.
Yeah, but you continue the conversation.
You bad. You know it. You know it. Not bad.
Okay. Sing
you
it.
You bad.
Sing it, Milford.
You know what I got to say about that?
What? What do you got to say about that?
There, my rooster's bigger than all y'all's.
Oh, see?
Yeah, the reason why his is bigger than that because it's computer generated.
Amplified.
That's right, my cock's amplified.
See there?
And computer generated cock.
Oh. And you know, that's all just a bunch of crap here at WBCW.
It's rooster crap.
It's rooster crap. What you got to say about that, Milford? He's still trying to get that crow in good.
Fake.
That was too funny. He's going to go back to his horse that he knows better. Oh, my gosh. You're too funny.
All right, do it again.
Get it crunk, big country.
He's got all
the buttons. Right.
He's got all the
buttons.
That's
all I got to say about
that. Yeah, he's got all kind of play toys.
Yep, he's got all the updated noises now.
So it sounds like Louisiana's having a rough time. They got more rain than they know what to do with. I guess South Texas is supposed to get in.
Yeah, what is with rain. That? Is that that's a front that's coming in from?
I don't know what the hell it is, but it's a lot of damn rain.
It might be.
Problem is we haven't had so much rain in the last few years that the ground's so dry it can't drain fast enough.
It don't saturate. It's oversaturated, but it don't soak in the ground.
Yeah, it's not draining.
It's just flowing off over on top.
When the ground's real dry like that, it doesn't soak up the water. It just kind of hovers. Kind of like driving on a slick road.
Like driving on ball tires on a wet road.
Yeah.
Well, you don't drive, you just slide.
Yeah, it goes where it wants to.
Hey, that rhymes. You don't drive, you just slide.
Hey, folks, she just thought of it.
Oh, shut up.
She got a light bulb on top of her head.
Give it a clap.
No, it's the applause. You got,
and the light just turned on.
Just because I say something, you got to be mean like that. That's it. You're in the freaking barn. That's right. You're
Florida
in the barn.
Power Corporation will be happy because every time Tammy thinks of something, their wattage goes up a couple kilograms.
No. Every time that you crack on me like that, you're going to the barn with the rest of the animals.
Well, I was born in a barn.
Well, then you get to freaking stay in the barn.
And his barn's got air conditioning.
Yeah, it's got air conditioning and one tiny little stall for a bathroom. No mirrors.
That's all guy needs.
And a hose out back to water the horse troughs.
That's all a guy needs.
Yeah, you can take your bath in the horse trough.
No, I already took my shower.
We got many more days left.
That's all right. Go to my dad's.
Whatever. I would think you'd go to your daughter's. She's closer.
I'll go to my dad's or my daughter's.
Does that mean you're just going to continue to be mean?
Or my uncle's right down the street.
You better shut up right now.
I got family even closer than that. Right down the street.
Fine.
God, you mean there's more Kirklands living in Apopka?
Tons of them.
Oh, jeez.
Cousins of cousins of cousins.
Yeah, the Shupers, the Buns, the Oxleys, and the Meeks.
What?
Yeah, they're all my cousins. Thompsons and Johnsons.
Are you proud of that?
You want to know who all my kin are?
I don't want to know about all your kin. I just said cousins of cousins of cousins.
See, and you thought you had a lot of people in Apopka.
She ain't got nobody in Apopka. What are you talking about?
How would you know?
They're from Kentucky.
No.
No, they're not. They're from Orlando.
They're from Crime Hill.
Hey. You are asking for that barn tonight, aren't you? You are ditching me every time.
I'm a Barbie girl in a Barbie world.
Didn't it say, don't it says Tammy's nightmare?
Yes, you're becoming my nightmare tonight.
Hi, I'm Chicky. You want to play?
Let's play.
Wow. We are. Okay.
Tammy comes from a concrete city.
Hey, I don't like it one bit. I should have been raised in the country.
Sweet dreams.
Shoulda, coulda, woulda.
I know it. I'm very mad at my family for that I got raised in the city and not the country. Found out about the country way too late in life. Shut up.
Which was only a few years ago, folks.
No, it wasn't. I've been out there 16 years now.
Not by choice.
Yes, by choice. What are you talking about, not by choice?
I don't know.
That's where I belonged all along. Unfortunately.
What, back in that sinkhole?
But I'm going to put you in the blue hole. That's where you're going to sleep.
I've been in the blue hole.
Blue hole? What the hell is
a,
what the hell is a blue hole?
But we're going to put you back in there. The blue hole is the springs. It used to be called blue.
Actually, it's a sinkhole behind the house in the area, and it actually opened up.
It's a cavern.
It's a cavern that goes down in.
It
started off as a sinkhole, and the caverns opened up. And everybody and all the divers and stuff would go back there.
And they'd go on out the rock springs.
And they would go and dive in.
To the caverns.
And go through the cave and stuff up going towards Rock Springs.
Yep. And they'd come up in Rock Springs.
But there's had too many
about
people.
About three of them that didn't come up in Rock Springs, and they got caught up under there, so they ended up closing it down many, many, many years ago.
Yeah,
they now they got a chain link fence around it that
everybody.
And
everybody's, they got bars. They got bars on there, too.
Not anymore.
They did.
They've tore that thing down many times. I mean, kids going back there partying.
Now, I remember hearing about them putting the bars on the one in Macaiva Springs, but
Rock Springs,
you're talking about behind your house, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you realize how far that is from going from your house to Rock Springs?
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's all caverns down there.
Yeah.
It's all the springs.
So basically, your whole neighborhood is sitting on a big freaking sinkhole.
They said that we've got all them springs underneath us. Our water's tapped into the one of the deep aquifers out there. And it's good water. Best water I've ever had.
When I lived
something ain't
the
right
house,
then, because I would, as a rule, they don't let nobody build any houses on land like that unless, of course, a lot of them houses are probably old anyway.
Yeah, they're very old.
Yeah.
Mine's in 1979.
Ain't old. My house is now built in 58.
That was built in 78, not 79.
Actually,
I remember when it was built.
No, that house?
Yeah.
I believe it's in 1979.
78.
You want to bet?
It might say 70 on a D, but that's when they was building it in 78.
Okay. Well,
when it got finished, that's when the D says 79.
Yeah.
Okay, mister. Not really, because the materials on a 1978 means that they could have lead-based paint in it. And in 1979, they banned lead-based paint from being used again in any houses. So that is a form that we have as realtors have to have people sign. So if it's built in 1978, they got to sign the form. If it's not built in 1978 and it's built in 1979 and up, they don't have to sign a form.
And if everybody wants and needs a realtor, call Tammy.
Okay, so
she is a professional realtor.
That is the law in Florida. So it's our house.
Go to T-Rolls at professionallyrealty.com.
It's built in 1979.
It's 78 and a half.
Okay. Only because you want it to be?
I know who used to, who built that house.
Who built it?
The Shores.
Okay, yeah, because the Shores were the original owners.
Yep.
Yep.
We all were friends with her kids.
How old are you again? How old are you again?
Turning 49.
Okay. How old am I again?
100 years old.
You are so in the barn tonight. That is it, buddy.
No, you're two.
You are in the barn.
Wait a minute. You're 18.
Yeah. You keep going with all that. You will be under the barn.
I've been under the barn too many times.
Well, you're going to be back under the barn. They'll have to dig you up.
No, I'll just dig out.
Like a mole?
You're digging them right. I used to dig tunnels.
Oh, my God.
You don't know where I'm going to pop up. Like a gopher or a prairie dog.
Okay. They don't bark.
Yeah, prairie dogs do.
They do not.
Yes, they do.
Yeah, they do.
And you are going to bark like a prairie dog up here again? All right. I'm going to have to Google that.
Fine. Don't believe me.
I'm going to have to Google the bark. Sound like a little yapper to me.
That's what they sound like. He's a little yapper.
Well, you are a little yapper. You had to deepen that tone up, didn't you? Now you sound like a woof. Now you're just blowing. Oof. All righty then. You're so funny.
I don't know.
And here's BC.
Mr. Quiet tonight.
Well, I was researching. I wanted to find out about that lead-based paint stuff.
It is. I got a form. At the house, trust me, I've got.
I don't believe anything you say.
That's LB1.
Well, I don't believe anything you say either.
They got a form called LB1.
And it's regarding the lead-based paint.
LBP. It's LBP form.
How do you know? Huh?
I'm smarter than an average redneck.
Okay, boo-boo.
Hey. Okay, Yogi. Let's go get some picnic basket.
It's 1978 is the lead-based paint.
I don't think Ranger Tammy will want you to get that picnic basket.
What'd you say?
I don't know, boo-boo.
Oh, the picnic basket.
Yeah, Ranger Tammy.
Well, better than Ranger Milford.
Ranger Halfpipe.
I have a picnic basket. A big one.
So you're saying lead-based paint was banned completely everywhere in 1978?
No, in residential. In residential is when they had to stop using it, and now there's the form that has to be signed when the home is 1978 or earlier. And if it's 1979 or later, then you don't have to sign the form because the house does not qualify, because by law they were not allowed to use lead-based paint after that.
It says here, although lead has been banned from household paints, in the U.S. since 1978, paint used in road markings may still contain it.
Yeah, well, we're talking about residential.
Alternatives such as water-based lead-free traffic paint are readily available. And many states and federal agencies have changed their purchasing contracts to buy these instead.
Right. Well, in homes, the purpose for that is when you go to tear a wall down and it's 1978 or earlier and it's got lead-based paint.
You don't have to worry about it. If it's 78 or earlier, you don't have to worry about lead-based paint because there'll be asbestos in it.
That too. So, in other words, the toxins that go into the air that actually cause all kinds of damage to children breathing it and adults, but mostly children.
Damage to half pint's brain.
No damage to Milford's brain. That's what's wrong with them.
Like I said, I was born in a barn. I wasn't born right.
Okay, well, at least you said that.
See, admission is nine tenths of the law. Admission is 10% of the recovery problem.
Okay, you're so funny. You definitely make me laugh.
I think I'm going to get everybody laughing at myself.
I know. Crack yourself up.
That's the reason they call me a crackhead.
Yeah, you crackhead.
And crackpot.
Toothless crackhead.
Those definitely ain't right.
Well,
I told you I wasn't right when I was born.
He warned us, that's for sure.
My mama, you tell you that. She could be a nut, too.
She was so cute today when she said her sweet little cute cowboy.
Well, Milford's mom was sending pictures to him this morning, or this afternoon.
Yeah, and
it was so sweet.
It was.
Well, I told you, she got a picture of me in my cowboy hat, my chaps, my vest, my two little six-shooters, my spurs and all that.
And I bet you they were assless chaps too, weren't they?
Yeah.
Well, he was a child. You're not supposed to be thinking of things like that.
What? No, when I had chaps, I wore shorts.
Well, he wore something.
I wore jeans, my chaps.
No, you had a thong on.
Oh, my God, no. Just because you want to have one on, don't mean he does. Jeez Louise.
Milford had a thong on. That's
no. At how old? 5 years old? I don't think so.
Oh, no, it was a diaper thong.
Oh, my Lord.
Did you even wear diapers back then?
Yeah, cloth.
Cloth diapers, yep. I did, too.
Yep.
No, you didn't. You ain't never wore a diaper in your life.
Well, how the hell would you know?
Depends don't count.
She can depend on him.
No, she can't, obviously.
10:42 p.m. right here. Here's your song, Tammy.
Oh, goodness.
But
WBCW Sunday night here, sitting on a tailgate. I wonder.
I think that
might have skipped a little bit. I don't know. The song was skipping. Sounded like it. I don't know if
it
was.
Yeah, sounded like it was skipped a little bit.
Wonder why.
I don't know.
Quit jumping on a turntable.
You're not knowing a whole lot tonight, are you?
This is going to be another long night trying to figure out what's going on. So anyways, we're talking about underoos. Milford had his Long Ranger underoos. Okay. I had Spider-Man or Superman. And then Tammy says she had Barbie underoos.
Barbie and Princess underoos. And then, you know, like, you'd get the 7 days of the week.
Well, and if you think about it, they kind of did look like G-strings back then, because when you wore them, they were like tighty-whities.
Yeah.
That's why I quit wearing tighty-whities. I can't stand tighty-whities. Boxers. That's all I wear is boxers.
Are you serious?
Yeah. And you go wear your Oshkosh B'gosh.
What the hell's that?
She ain't never heard of Oshkosh B'gosh. Jeez.
I don't even know if I want to know.
Tell her, Milford.
It's a clothing line from Wisconsin.
Okay.
For kids.
Okay, they've Oshkosh. Been around. All right. Well, you called it something else.
They call it Oshkosh B'gosh.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't hear, never hear the end of that one. Only know Oshkosh.
Well,
I think she listens to what she wants to listen to.
Yeah, she turns her hearing aid off one ear.
I have selective hearing.
Yeah, she turns both ears down.
That's right. I can turn them off. Drowned you out. Moms can do that really good.
No, that just means that just means your hearing aids aren't working right.
Yeah, you need to go buy a new pair.
Shut up, Milford.
Or just replace the batteries.
Yeah, batteries are a problem.
Oh, no, actually.
Yeah, she has a problem of keeping batteries in the house.
That's right.
Yeah, she's got to go recharge them.
No, I just got to buy new ones.
No, they do have rechargeables.
Well, I'm not going to do rechargeable. They don't give as much energy.
I'm talking about hearing aids, and she's talking about something else.
I know.
We're talking about batteries.
We was on the subject of hearing aids.
No, we weren't. He got on the subject of batteries, and you got on the subject of rechargeables, and I got on the subject.
Yeah, we started talking about hearing aids.
Well, no kidding. And you started in with the batteries.
Yeah, to change the batteries.
Yeah, batteries on hearing aids. My dad does it all the time.
Yeah, and then they
got little tiny watch batteries.
I wouldn't know.
They also got USB ports on them now, where you go or get.
How do you know all this, Milford?
To put your hearing aids in, where they charge by itself.
How do you know all this? You got one?
Huh?
Huh? You got one?
Huh?
You need to turn it up.
Huh?
Or charge it.
What'd you say?
I want to be there with a camera when they come knocking on Tammy's door in the geriatrics department and say, hey, this is all the stuff that you're going to need when you get older.
Nobody's going to tell me what I
need. Rectal,
yeah. Hearing aids. You might even need a pee bag when you're walking around town.
I think you guys are going to need a lot more than me.
A colostrum bag?
No, you're going to need that. Actually,
do we need to go down to the medical supply store and already set up an account for you, Tammy? Because you'll have to get one of them walkers, too, and you might even a cane to... Don't forget about the potty stool, the potty seat that you're going to need over top of the toilet at the house.
Oh, you would...
And you're going to need the shower chair so you don't slip like and fall in the shower.
Well, I already gave her a shower.
Gave her a shower chair?
Well, I got a shower chair. No, actually, she's already got one.
Oh, he's got a shower chair. See?
Yeah, when I got hurt.
He's giving himself away. Yep, and he's got that colostal bag, and he's got the little...
I got the colostal bag.
The little butt cushion thing.
No, I don't.
Where you sit, and you got to sit on the little cushion.
No, it's not called a colostal bag. It's a colostomy bag.
And he's got all that kind of stuff.
I ain't got all that. I had a shower chair. Dude, because when I broke my pelvic bone, dead center.
That's right.
I couldn't sit all the way down in the tub or stand up.
I don't want to hear your excuses.
That ain't an excuse. That's the truth. So I got a plate and six screws and I'm put together.
Okay, Humpty Dumpty.
From bull riding.
Humpty Dumpty. What are you doing? Acting all goofy over there.
Jeez.
It just got interesting, folks.
It did? How did it just get interesting?
We're here for the 2016 Olympics here in Rio, and it's Milford against Tammy.
Oh, no.
They are doing the 100-meter freestyle shower chair race.
Oh, gosh.
Milford's got his souped up with wheels, and Tammy's got tennis balls on the end of hers.
They're all excited because they're watching the volleyball.
I ain't watching nothing.
Somebody is.
She has no idea.
Nope.
What are you talking about?
She hasn't a clue.
No, I have no clue about you crazy freaking.
She's like, yeah, television program.
She'll be calling the Social Security office saying, hi, this is Barbie. I was in a Barbie's world, but now I'm in a geriatric office.
No, I got long ways before that goes.
Just like a TV program. Clueless.
Mm-hmm. Oh, shut up, Milford. I swear to God, you are going to be in big trouble. That's all there is to it. Do you understand?
Well, you just
big trouble and little Apopka.
That's right. Big trouble.
You did say he was blonde and brunette in the sky, clueless.
No, I never said clueless, but you're stating things like this, and it's not very nice. So, you're in big trouble, buddy boy.
Listen here, sinkhole.
Listen here, snatch roper. Snatch rope or whatever the frick you got on your damn.
Snatch roper.
I couldn't read it. Snatch rope.
You could have come up better than a snatch roper on that one.
Listen here, monkey face. Stop saying things like that about me.
What are we saying?
Well, you could have came
you.
Up. I ain't saying nothing about you.
Yes, you are.
You could have came. Right, up, you could have came up better than a snatch roper.
No, I was reading what's on the back of his computer there.
But there's no roper in it.
Rope. Yeah. But it's got this whole little thing all around it, so it looked like it says, "See at the very end, roper."
No.
Do you see?
R-O-P-E, that's all it says.
Well, I'm from an angle over here. So
are you sure you're not the one that's dyslexic?
So I'm at an angle over here. I can only see it.
She must be on.
You're at an angle? Hey, give her your glasses so she can read it.
No, I'm serious.
She needs reading glasses now.
I'm at
see,
an
it's
angle.
Already started.
See?
It's already started. Yeah. I'm telling you.
I know. She
play
on,
some
she's,
music.
She's
or
on
something.
Some good meds right now.
It's already started.
Lordy B. Guys, you are something else.
You could have came out with goat rope. Go, Roper.
No, I was trying to read what was on his computer. On the back of it.
Well, you could say anus finger.
See? Now, who's gonna mess up everything right there?
I bet you drink a can of Venture every morning, don't you?
Shut up. I don't even know what that is. I don't even know what you said, actually.
I said you drink a can of Ensure every morning, don't you?
No. Actually, people who are sick do that.
No.
Yes. It's for people that are sick and need nutrition, things like that.
You got half of it, right? But not everything.
No.
Ensure is for old people that doesn't have enough vitamins.
It is
and
not.
Yeah, it is.
When my son was in the hospital, they used to give it to him because he couldn't
eat. Because he needed supplements. That's what Ensure is.
Yeah. Vitamins and all that.
Right.
I had to get me some muscle milk this morning.
Your body, what? Tammy, your body starts to deteriorate.
What did you just say?
I said I had to drink a thing of muscle milk this morning.
Muscle milk?
Yeah.
Yep.
Why, to get your muscles going?
No, it's protein and stuff in my body.
Protein. Your body starts to break down when you hit 45.
It does not.
You want to bet?
You know what?
I'm 45, and it started on me when I was 40.
Okay, well, some people, it's
ain't
different
going
than
down
others.
Here.
Some people are much
no,
different
that's,
than others.
No, that's known
it's
fact.
It's also how,
that's on,
how well
that's
you take care
people.
Of yourself. It's all in what you eat and how much you eat and how little.
It's actually in your...
It's in your genes. It's
in genetics.
Your genetics, that's right.
It's hereditary.
It's in everybody's hereditary. It's hereditary
yeah,
in everybody.
Yeah, but it runs different in everybody's genetics. So you don't know. And my genetics is different than yours.
I'm so glad for that.
Thanks. Me too.
And that now is the rest of the story. And back to you.
We all get old. It's a known fact. She ain't
all right, guys.
I just get senile.
Well, yeah, you're more than that.
Tammy, you're getting old.
You better shut up.
Tammy, you'll be like that guy that jumps out of the TV in that movie Poltergeist. Don't look into the light!
I've never watched that, so...
Scott says, Snatch Trooper.
Yeah, there you go, Snatch... That's too funny.
Hey, Scott, you laughing your head off yet? Are you rolling on the floor?
That's not what was on the back of his... computer, though.
I got a sticker on the back of my computer.
Snatch
rope.
Rope, but I'm at an angle, so it looks like it says roper. So I'm
do you even know
that.
What snatch rope is?
Do I?
Yeah.
You do.
I know I do. Do you know what it is?
No. Nope.
I know what a snatch rope is.
I know he does.
Well, I would think it's something to pull vehicles with.
Oh.
She's getting a little smart there.
Shut up. I already knew. I got stuff in my...
No, you didn't, because you just said you didn't know what it was.
Well, at first...
At first what?
At first glance.
At first glance. Shut up, Steve. I swear. You know what? You can kiss my butt. How about that?
That might be an all-day job.
Well, I don't know. It's not that big.
It'd be about a five-second job.
Okay, I'm done. Let's go back to work.
Yep, Scott's laughing on the floor already.
Hey, these guys are something else. I'm not always ready for y'all when you start bombarding me with your meanness.
And Scott needs another vacation.
I'm sure he does. He needed another vacation. He needed a vacation from his vacation.
For another vacation. Have you figured anything out yet?
Yep, I'm figuring it's 10:50. Nope.
No, it's
11 o'clock. 11 p.m. right here at WBCW. Hang tight. We'll be right back.
Baby, lay down. Move a little closer. Put your head on my shoulder. Let's get to making love right now. The world outside sure can get a little crazy. But you and me, baby, know just how to make it all right. So get ready to kiss our troubles goodbye. And let's just love it away. Put a beautiful end to a real bad day in each other's arms. Who cares what tomorrow brings? We've got tonight, if you know what I mean. We're all alone.
So what do you say? Let's just love it away. That 9 to 5, when it gets to me and you, we can look forward to looking in each other's eyes. Oh, baby, I swear, when we get together, we can make it all better. Leave all our worries out there. We can make them all just disappear. Hey, let's just love it away. Put a beautiful end to a real bad day in each other's arms. Who cares what tomorrow brings? We've got tonight, if you know what I mean. We're all alone. So what do you say? Let's just love it away. Say, let's just love it away. Love it away. Love it away.
WBCW Sunday night here, hanging with you. It's Tammy's Nightmares.
Yeah, these guys are my nightmare.
Whatever.
You are. You have been my nightmare.
You were
tonight.
The one that invented both a nightmare. Of you. Poltergeist and Freddy Krueger.
I've not watched either one.
Halloween?
Nope. I don't watch scary movies.
Public service announcement. If you'd like to see Tammy live in person this year, go to Walt Disney World for Halloween Horror Nights this year, and you will see.
Man, what a nice guy he is, right? I mean, Lord. Yeah, you want to see BC, go to Cinderella's Castle where they got Goofy and
is that the best you'd come up with?
Humpty Dumpty.
I know, right?
People. Well, you said you were one of the bears there.
The bear,
that's got his butt sticking out of the wall.
The Country Bear Jamboree hasn't been at Disney World for a long time.
I haven't been there.
Yeah, I miss that. That was my favorite part.
That was one of mine, too. I used to love it. Why'd they take that out?
Well, I guess to make room for other stuff.
And it's just like,
easy small world after all.
Right?
They still got that, don't they, that ride?
No.
No, they closed it.
They closed the small world. Yep.
Yep.
That used to drive you crazy going past that.
If you want to see, hey, there, I hear that right there.
You hear the snap crackling?
Snap,
yeah,
crackle, pop.
What's the deal with that?
Back connection. Oh. That's what it is, back connection.
It's somewhere.
Somewhere?
Yeah, back in action.
Yeah, so anybody that's out there listening would like to donate to the United Fat Boys Foundation of WBCW.
Or the Crazy Cowboy Fund.
Yep, we'd like to get some.
Or Half Pint Fund.
We'd like to get new equipment. It don't cost much. We're looking for donations of $10,000 each. So just let us know.
$10,000 each.
But then $10 donation would be appreciative.
Yes. This is true. We've also started something. Everybody knows that we got a GoFundMe page right now. Everybody knows that October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and we're going to try to raise $5,000 to donate to the Florida Hospital Breast Cancer Foundation. So I've done stuff over the years with Breast Cancer Month in October. So Check out our GoFundMe page. You can get it from, there's a link on our website at WBCWradio.com, or you can also go to our Facebook page here at WBC or Facebook.com/WBCWradio, and it'll give you the GoFundMe link if you want to donate whatever. Whatever you feel like donating will be much appreciated.
So I guess you need to go get yourself checked on your breast disease.
I did. I had a lump 3 years ago, and I went and got a mammogram, and it was nothing. It was just fat.
Oh.
They said that the statistics, I looked this up the other day, statistics for this year in 2016, that 440 men will die from breast cancer.
Yeah, Scott just posted something. JFK Airport, New York, shut down. Breaking news, shots fired, all flights are suspended.
Wow. Probably another crazy loose.
That's just New York.
That's, yeah. Pretty much.
I mean, they don't have that happening very often, though, I'm sure.
Wow.
But it, hopefully it's not terrorism.
Either that or some drunken idiot.
That's what I'm saying.
It's probably something.
I'm sorry. Nobody in there in America in their right mind is going to go shoot up an airport. And I say in their right mind.
Exactly. So they're not in their right mind. Hopefully it's just that and not terrorism. Like, you know.
Now Scott's saying they're not. They are not sure. So
terrorists.
It could. I'm sure it'll be on the news tonight.
Yeah, it'll be on. Well, turn it over to the news. We'll find out because it's after 11. It's 11:08 here on WBCW, Florida's Country Radio. If you wanted to know the time. Huh. All right.
Something else, sir.
Yeah, something else.
See, Scott says so far 2 reports of shots fired.
Well, wouldn't it be on...
It'll be on Channel 6.
It'll be on Channel 6.
Developing story.
Yep. We'll find out here.
They say, investigators tell us that Deputy Daniel Carrero...
That's Simi.
...were found dead inside a car at the Speedway.
Murder suicide.
Yep.
Wow, that's crazy.
What is this world coming to?
A whole lot of nothing.
Now, this is cool.
What's cool?
This seat here of this old, look at this. It's 2 farms, I guess, what are they called? Tractor seats? Those metal seats?
Yeah.
And they're welded to a back of a really cool metal bed. And then 2 of those, what kind of wheels are those?
Oh, tractor wheels.
Are they tractor wheels?
Yep.
The metal ones?
Yep.
That is really cool.
Here's something that gets me, too. They're talking about, since the Pulse shooting in downtown Orlando at the nightclub, it's been now, what, almost 3 months, and not one single person has seen any of that money yet.
Nope.
Well, you said they never will.
No, because Orlando...
No, they'll drag it out. They'll drag it out as long as... they'll because you got to fill out paperwork now and this and that. They'll guarantee they'll drag it out as long as they can.
Yeah, while they're paying off the
debt. Because Orlando, the mayor is so...
Crooked.
He figures, oh, we got $23 million. That'll pay off the Citrus Bowl.
That's what I was getting to.
Or that'll pay off the SunRail that taxpayers have been paying for now for the last 2 years.
And it ain't worth a cahoot.
Yep.
Wasted.
They figure they can take all that one lump sum and take care of their bills, and then they can pay the city. The city can pay money to these people a little bit at a time. I guarantee that's what they're thinking.
Yeah, that's why.
Well, if he's a crook, then he's going to find avenues for that money for himself.
The government's all crooks.
For himself.
The whole judicial system's a bunch of crooks.
Well,
crooks.
That's why people run for these seats for the Senate and House and all that stuff.
For money.
Well, no, they get in there because they know they got money set for life. And 2, they know if anything ever happens, they get caught doing something wrong, they're not going to get touched. They will never spend a day in jail.
Yep, because crooks support crooks.
That's not good.
A government person, he'll go embezzle money. He may get probation. A white boy or a black boy out on the streets, buddy, they'll lock his butt up for years.
Yeah.
And make him pay the money back.
Yeah, or the
pay
little
restitution.
Guy. Or the little guy paying taxes. Yep. And if you, like, owe $300-$400 just because you didn't get... Actually, I owe a little over $500 because I didn't get Obamacare.
Yep.
Because I didn't get Obamacare, I got to pay the government. And all my taxes, I thought I had all my receipts and everything. And when I found that out, I was like, what the heck? $500-something just because I didn't have Obamacare. It's like, I'd rather pay it than have it just because they told me I had to have it.
Well, I didn't have to pay it.
Why didn't you have to pay it? Why didn't you get charged?
Why?
Yeah.
Because I told them I was a poor white boy.
Well, I told them I'm a poor white girl.
And I said...
They knew better than that.
And so what's the deal? What? How come I have to pay $500?
That's because they seen your cartoon shows back in the day.
$500, $600
In a Barbie world.
Huh?
Well, I told them. Well, I told you to tell them.
I told them. I told them I couldn't afford it. I had to eat and... And put gas in my car and stuff. That was more important to me than...
Yeah, but you made more than me.
Well, evidently. Sucks.
That's where I stay in agriculture.
You stay in Correct. Agriculture. Whatever.
We'll play this song. This will explain everything. 11:13, stand by. We'll be right back.
Lawyers in football, baseball's got a few. The pitcher got $1 million and the quarterback he got two. Pitcher threw his arm away and the quarterback ruined his knees. And this they did so they could live the American dream. Now there are some preachers on TV with a suit and a tie and a vest. They want you to send your money to the Lord, but they give you their address. 'Cause all of your donations are completely tax-free. God bless you all, but most of all, send your money. Do you really want it? Do you really need it? You gotta keep on grinding. Dreaming the American dream. Reagan is a cutting the budget, making the Democrats scream. Says we gotta control inflation, quit spending our money on everything. But this year's tax increase, why, it's the biggest in history. Round and around we go, where we stop, who knows? The American dream. Do we really want it? Do you really need it? We gotta keep on grinding just to try to keep it. We got no time for ourselves and more for old Jim Beam. We're going crazy dreaming the American dream. We're going crazy dreaming the American dream.
Brian Webb has more. WBCW Sunday night.
Neighbors on Milwaukee's north side cleared debris Sunday after several cars and buildings were set.
We're sitting here watching about the stuff that went down in Milwaukee, Wisconsin last night. That's ridiculous. I mean, it's just
over somebody, a criminal getting shot by a police officer. It's just crazy.
And granted, it was a black cop shooting a black kid.
Yeah.
And they're still right. So that's why I say it's not about race anymore. It's about cops. They hate cops.
It's about authority.
It's about authority is what it is, really.
You know, this there's a lack of authority, appreciation for authority in our cops and stuff in the world.
Servicemen and women.
And because we need them. If we didn't have them, we would have so much disorder that we'd all have to own guns and everybody be killing everybody. Yep. Be like the West.
Well, and it's funny. It's funny, too, up here in Sanford. The whole thing with the Trayvon Martin issue being the fact that Chief Lee, he's a white police officer. He was a white chief. They threw him out of Sanford Police Department because they figured they needed somebody better in that position. So they brought in a black chief from Cleveland, Ohio. That didn't help the situation. Nothing changed.
Nothing changed, I know.
And Chief Lee is now working for the Florida Department of Law Enforcement, making twice as much as he was making at Sanford.
Yeah, working for FDLE.
Yep. Somebody's always got to be a fall guy about something.
Yeah.
Well,
a patsy.
I think it's a shame that they're attacking our police officers who are only trying to keep the peace plus keep order. What if we had no order?
Mm-hmm.
You know, we would all be thinking twice.
It'd be like the Wild Wild West.
Exactly. But it would be even worse because people are just much more ruthless.
Yep.
At least in the Wild West, you know.
You stood out in front high noon, buddy. It was one-on-one and that was it.
But not here. Not the way this is all going. They're just going to...
they'll just open up with
pillage and plumage. Yeah. What do they call it?
Vandalize.
Vandalize. Hurt people. They're just... It'll be terrible. I mean, you'll have to own a gun in order to protect yourself or your belongings.
Yep.
That's the reason why, when it comes down to it, horses, turn the phone off, take your battery out, nobody can find you.
Yeah, we got to go where nobody can find you.
Oh, stealth mode, you're in the woods.
Well,
I got enough stuff in my shed out there.
You know how many people be out in Ocala Woods? I mean, what's the biggest thick?
No, I wouldn't even go there.
I wouldn't even go there.
That'd be the first place they'd look.
Yeah. Where would you go?
Oh, I know.
There's places I'm sure he knows and I know that they wouldn't even think to look.
Yeah.
Well.
Especially on a horse.
Yeah, but you can't take everybody. You can't take your whole family. You can't take the little babies. I mean, that kind of stuff. What we really need is like my Hummer back or a tank. That way.
You just need to build underground bomb shelters.
I got an underground situation.
Yeah, but it's falling apart.
I know. I don't have nobody to secure it.
Actually, that needs to be taken out.
I know it.
And get a steel.
Yeah, that would be cool. But steel would rust unless it was a good kind of steel.
Which
containers? Galvanized.
Galvanized, yeah.
Container.
Yeah, galvanized.
Containers.
Are they galvanized?
Yeah. That's what they ship
overseas.
That's
in there now.
No.
No, it was just a
regular
trailer.
53-foot trailer.
Yep.
What? You got a trailer underground at your house?
Shh.
That's a school bus. That ain't no damn trailer.
No, it's actually a refrigeration trailer.
Mm-hmm. It's all rotted and falling in, though.
I ain't going to your house no more. Hell, I might step in the wrong spot and go down in the ground about 10 feet.
No, it's all protected.
Damn, got trailers in the yard that's underground.
You got
natural springs and caverns and everything else.
Yeah, I do. We got horses. And
somebody needs to call the EPA on these people.
Oh, there's the weather there.
Looks like we got a storm, maybe.
Yeah, but look what's
tropical
over here.
Depression.
See that? That's hitting.
Yeah, it's
that's hitting Texas. That's what all that rain that they're talking about.
And that ain't going to let up in Louisiana.
And it's coming back up, hit Florida again, so.
That's crazy.
September is the peak of hurricane season.
Yep. Remember the last hurricane season we had? The last hurricane hit in February?
Was it in February?
Well, actually,
it was October.
February, believe it or not, February.
It was March.
February started a new year because even though hurricane season runs from June to November, it's still, being it was in 2016, that's when they started it over for the new year. So.
Yep.
AM rain gear?
Yep, it's going to be 77 degrees tomorrow.
Not here.
Yeah, it said Florida.
No, there's the temperature for tomorrow right there.
I know.
It's 77 right now, probably.
88 degrees.
93 at 4 p.m.
88 at
It was talking rain in the morning, though.
There's your rain. 40, yeah. 40, 40, 50 on Thursday.
Yeah, but you know how Florida is. It can say 40 all day long and go right around.
Well, I used to be able to set my clock every afternoon at 3 o'clock and it'd start to rain.
I know. It used to be like that.
Well, it's trying to get back that way.
It depends on the El Nino.
The Earth has a cycle. We're in the backside of the cycle. Because
aren't we in the El Nino again?
Well, something like that. But the cycle is supposed to rotate every, 30 or 40 years. So we're actually on the backside of it, and we're getting ready to start to get back in the pattern that we seen back in the 80s and 90s.
So when did the Earth, where it depends?
What are you talking about? Steve.
Yeah, I have no idea what you're talking about.
Milford.
She said, it depends on the Earth. I said, just wonder when the Earth decides where it depends.
Since it started raining a lot. Well, I figured if he can do a corny joke, I can do, right?
Sure, why not?
Anything goes.
See, you ain't always that funny.
In Timmy's nightmare.
That's right, my nightmare. You guys are my nightmare.
We better play Scott's song for him. If we don't,
his American dream.
He'll have a fit. But we're not going to play the new one you sent me, Scott, because I ain't got it loaded yet. We'll play one of your other ones.
Well, he wants to hear his new one.
Jukebox, baby.
He'll just have to wait until...
That one's a good
Wednesday.
One.
Yeah.
I can't even find his name. There he is.
Yeah, you're lost. You, Scott.
You're lost, Scott.
He says, who, me?
Mm-hmm. All right.
It's the other Brant on the other side.
Yeah, it's the other Scott.
11:23 p.m. right here at WBCW. We'll be back in a second. Hang tight.
World's menu for the weekend. I can hardly wait for Friday to get here. Cause the weekend comes and the weekend goes, and I hardly think I drank one beer. Or maybe I can find us a little cabin up on the lake. We can have some wine and drink us a good time, making love till the sun breaks. Turn off the news, turn off your flat screen TV. Go grab your flip-flops and go with me. I'm gonna take a vacation, watch the sunrise from the beach. Have a drink in my hand and my feet in the sand, and your beautiful eyes looking at me. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Is it two for one or one for two? I had to make this one for me and you. Cause the sand is out and the water feels cool. Not bad for a Monday at noon. Turn off the news, turn off your flat screen TV. Go grab your flip-flops and go with me. I'm gonna take a vacation, watch the sunrise from the beach. Have a drink in my hand and my feet in the sand, and your beautiful eyes looking. I don't care where we go as long as you're with me. Out here on a boat sailing the seven seas. Sunrise from the beach. Have a drink in my hand and my feet in the sand, and your beautiful eyes looking at me.
WBCW Sunday night here, sitting with Tammy's nightmares.
Yeah, my nightmares.
Yeah,
all
Scott
right.
Brandt was vacation. He's another one.
Is that who it was? I thought it was what's his face.
Who's what's his face?
I don't know.
The other Scott?
Yeah.
The other one that we've been talking about.
The other Scott.
The other Brandt. Scott.
The other Scott Brandt.
Yeah.
The other good looking one. The one that's going to look more good looking than the other one.
So you walked into that one, Milford.
So we're going to, let's see, we're going to be talking with White Acres Wednesday night on the show here on Sitting on Tailgate, talking to the girls and see what is going on with their music. I know they've been doing some gigs and shows around Nashville and whatnot, and see about what when they got new music coming out. And then ain't got nobody booked for the 24th yet. Or do I? No, I don't. The 31st, we got Christina Taylor. And then next month, the first week of next month, we have Mercy Stone, the two girls that has been blowing up Nashville and doing their shows and stuff. So we're going to talk about them. And my buddy, Vic Clevenger, he's going to be coming in the studio with us on a Sunday. Haven't figured out which one yet, though. He's going to come in. You think Willie's good? Vic's going to be just as good.
Has he been on your radio before?
Before I even started mine, me, Vic, Bubba Wilson from Monsters, and J.B. Webb, another buddy of mine, we originally started, well, J.B. started it, and I was just guesting on it, but they started a show called Grits and Gravy, a talk show just like this, and we did it in the mornings.
Cool.
And of course, Bubba got busy doing his gigs because he plays piano and stuff like that, and he sings a lot at Pat O'Brien's, or he used to. And then Vic was doing his thing with his comedy acts, and JB Webb's still doing his shows on his network. It's WJBW Networks. Matter of fact, he's also on Spreaker too. So. But we all just kind of split and
just had things to do.
Yeah, went our own different ways and doing things different. So, but
so that was on Saturday.
How do you do all them damn fancy things on there?
Just like you do on your computer.
What fancy things?
The pictures and the faces and everything else. Well, you're doing them from your phone though, right?
Right.
Okay, see, that's...
They're in the list of things when you, like, yeah.
Oh, ho, ho, ho,
on the happy face.
No, they aren't, actually, because if you look at my screen here on the chat rooms doesn't have it. You actually got to be on an iPad or a phone or an iPad to do them.
It's the phone that's got them. Each phone's got their own type of things that they can put on there.
A machine challenge.
Scott says he's got some winds and heavy rain. Well, stop peeing in the damn water fountain, will you?
Yeah, and pee the other way so it don't come back in your face.
Well, that bites.
Pool stuff all over.
Good
the place.
Thing it's there, not here.
How are you going to own a swimming pool and not tie your stuff down there,
We don't tie
Mr.
our
Brandt.
Down umbrellas and tables. You don't tie that stuff down.
Well, that's because most of your stuff's up underneath the overhang.
No. That's probably what he's talking about, all the stuff that's out around the pool. The wind will take the tables and everything. Mm-hmm. I don't have anything out there.
You need to, see if you had stuff, you're lucky too, because if you had stuff out there, see, that would be a missile towards your horses.
Exactly. I try to keep all that cleared away. I'm quite all right with it. I have no reason to have it all anyway. Everybody will come over there and use it when I'm not around.
Or steal it.
Nobody's going to steal it. Now I got the gates locked.
No, sir.
They just come over and use it and break it and
not,
stuff.
Not if certain people quit taking giving the
code out.
Combination.
I know it. We have to change combination again. Now too many people know.
And just thinking, you got a studio that you're getting ready to put together.
Well, that thing's going to be on lockdown. There's no windows in it either.
That don't mean nothing. You said your son's going to be in there too, right?
Yeah. Yeah, but he knows
I'm putting some video cams in.
He knows to keep certain people away too. He's learned because we had that talk already. We've had that talk.
Okay. I didn't say anything.
I mean, you know, you got that look like, uh-huh, sure.
I didn't say a word.
No, it was the way you looked.
You still got them people living back there, right?
Yeah, but I ain't worried about them.
When you start thinking that way, then that's when you got to start worrying.
The doors are going to be locked. They're not going to be in that room. The doors stay locked now. And we will have video cameras up.
And plus, I'll have motion sensor lights up.
Yeah, we're going to have motion sensor lights up.
And I got a Dusk of Dawn light up.
How are you going to do that with the horses running around out there?
They're not running around the outside like that. No. They're only running. Well, we do. We have
Cinnamon and CJ.
And you got the dogs?
No, dogs stay inside.
They stay inside.
Don't you got cats out there?
One cat. One. That's it.
Well, that's, yeah, but the motion detector, will they detect that?
Yeah, but no, what it is, I'm going to have a Dusk to Dawn security light come on.
Yeah. We got a Dusk to Dawn for.
Yeah.
For the front.
For the one that's going to be up there? That's a motion detector or Dusk to Dawn?
Dusk to Dawn.
I just put up a halogen light right there in front on the barn.
Well, we already bought it, so it's the Dusk to Dawn.
Yeah.
And then we got
one of them big
halogen. Yeah, I know. Yeah. I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, but that burns all the time. That means it burns electricity.
No, it's Dusk to Dawn, too.
It's Dusk to Dawn.
Okay.
It goes off.
I got the one that's LED.
Yeah, so it saves.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm trying to save power.
We have to, because that barn and that rental back there are connected, and that
runs more than the house and Jimmy's house.
Yeah, do you know that bill's going up? We got to check that out.
If that bill's going up, then there's something wrong.
Something going on here. Well.
Well, he did put a window unit in over there.
I know.
That'll make it go up.
That's what I'm saying. I need
and
to get that.
Especially if the window, the window unit's running all the time.
And on top of it, and you know it is. And he probably doesn't have it sealed proper. And you know that window unit's still in the bottom.
He put that one in.
Huh?
Recently.
Oh, is that the one he put in? Not the one on the top?
No.
So there's not one on the top
floor. Yeah, there's one on top floor that's going to be taken out.
I thought it was taken out.
Right? It was taken out, but he put another one in.
Okay, well, we need to get those out. This guy's freaking driving me nuts. Because I can't afford it. Their bill's going up higher than my two houses.
And you're a realtor.
People, what does that got to do with anything?
She's one of them slumlords.
No. I've done tried to fix that place.
Tammy's a slumlord and a realtor at the same time.
You stop it. I put central AC and heat in there, didn't we?
You put central AC and heat in that.
Yes, I
hunk
did.
Of junk.
And I'm not a slumlord, and I tried to get it all fixed up nice for them. They went down there and
then
did
you
all
need
kinds
to get rid of the people.
I know. That's the problem.
And we've talked about that, and I've told you how to do it.
Well. It's hard when you got a they got three kids down there.
There's a time to be.
That's the part I have a problem with my son right there. He's too soft about it.
It's one thing to have empathy for somebody, but when it comes to affecting the way of your life and your property and stuff like that.
And finances.
Got to go.
I know. That's the truth. I feel the same way, but he's, you know.
That's why my last girlfriend lived here 6 months and ran up my electric bill, and I kicked her out. I told her dad, I said, I'm bringing her home. He said, no, you ain't. I said, yes, I am. And I did. I brought her right back on the front porch and dropped her off.
Too expensive. Some people just don't care.
Yeah, I'd go out to work during the day, and I'd come home, and the damn windows would be wide open. This is the middle of summertime. Windows would be wide open.
AC on.
She'd be, yep, AC on. All TVs in the house on. All the lights in the house on.
She didn't
and she'd be next door talking to the neighbor.
She didn't have to pay for any of it.
Nope.
That's why. That's how people typically will do.
Yep. All right, Milford, tell us what's going on in October before we sign off.
Okay, in October, Rowdy Johnson Band will be here on October 7th through the 9th. Rowdy will be at Apopka Elks Club on the 7th for Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and it's a donations or it's a donate it's for donations event donations event. So donations will be appreciative. All the Apopka Chamber of Commerce and all the big wigs are going to be there. Watching Rowdy Johnson and his band to get to see how he does to do the Apopka Amphitheater next year in February. Also, too, if you can, and that starts at 7 or 8 o'clock.
7.
7 o'clock on the 7th. And if you cannot make that event, Rowdy would also be in Apopka also at the Bat Ranch. All right. Go ahead.
Well,
go ahead.
You were just stumbling around there.
That's just me.
Okay. All right. So go ahead.
If you can't make that event, come down to the Bat Ranch on Plymouth Runner Road.
Mr. Pig's in the room.
Gates open at 6. It's BYOB. $10 at the door.
Starts at 7.
Kids under 12 are free. Bring your family, friends, and everybody else you can think of. And let's have that's the Rowdy Johnson Homecoming Bash Party there. If you cannot make that event, come over here to Sanford Wolfies. And show starts at 8 or 9 o'clock on the 9th. So it's going to be a fun-filled, packed weekend. And also on the 8th, I will be there. Open up for Rowdy Johnson and representing WBCW. Florida Country Radio.
Make sure you go check out our website, WBCWradio.com. Also, our radio station is at WBCWradio.com, where you can hear music 24 hours a day. We're going to be talking with White Acres this Wednesday night here, sitting on a tailgate starting at 8 p.m. Eastern Time. And don't forget, the Top 20 Countdown ends this coming Saturday night at 11 p.m., the show will be aired Sunday at 8 p.m. You get 10 chances a day to go vote. Make sure you go vote for your favorite artist. Go to WBCWradio.com. Click on the Top 20 Countdown link. Highlight your favorite artist or click on the bubble on the left-hand side. Go down to the bottom of the page and click vote to make sure your vote counts. That about does it for us. Say goodbye, Tammy.
Goodbye, everybody.
Oh, jeez. Milford.
Hasta luego.
Hasta luego. Bye-bye. Until then, I'm Big Country. We're going to send you out here.
Later, Gators.
With this song. Have a good night. Have a great finish to the weekend. Of course, weekend's almost done. Have a good day at work tomorrow. Most everybody's going back to school, so. Hasta luego.
See ya.
There's a wife left in last year. The kids never called. Now he's all washed up. His back is against the wall. He never thought his life would turn out this way. He used to be a real cowboy, and he's not today. He's just a broken cowboy trying to get back home. We'll be right back.
broken down. They can't cowboy up no more, no more traveling around. His heart is big as Texas, but his soul is flat and broke, just like his cowboy's dream.